shende de boss. Raga ba 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 sende kula da ba ba. Rende de boss shanda da ba boss. Ye mama ma sende de boss. We run da da boss sende ke ye. You are worthy, Lord, you are worthy. Ma shanda da boss. Raga ba sende kula da boss shanda da 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 da. Mas kende de boss shende he. Rababo sende hude lido kayata. Lord, we worship you, we worship you, we worship you, we worship you, we bless your holy name, we adore you. Maskende de boshanda. We are here to worship you, Jesus. We are here to worship you, Jesus. We are here to worship you, Jesus. We are here to bow down. We are here to say that you are our God. Hallelujah. Rabababa shanda rabo sende. Rende de boskende. Manda kalete kuyete. Jesus, you are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy. Mashende de boskende. Here we are to worship you. Here we are to bow down. Here we are to say you are our God. Father, there is no one like you, Jesus. Randa boskende de boshanda. Oh, God bless you. God bless you, Sister Helen. God bless you, Sister Martha. God bless you, everyone. You are all welcome in the name of Jesus. Randabos. Yes, he is. He is indeed a faithful God. He is a very faithful God. Mashandarabos. We will never know how much it costs to see our sin upon the cross. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for dying for us. We are grateful. We are grateful, Lord. Hallelujah. Here we are to worship him. Do you have a reason to worship him? Here we are to say that he's our God. Rabba boshende kuladabas. Maskende de boshende. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. We just bless you. We just bless you. Randa bashende. Good evening, Sister Vivian. You are all welcome in Jesus' name. Mata Kurada Bose. Hello. Brother Kingsley, you are welcome in Jesus' name. Manda Kuyete Bolide Kayata. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Maskende de boshanda da da da. Just worship him, worship him, worship him. Worship him. He's too faithful. Our God is too great. He's too much. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Nende kayata, nede kayata. Nede kayata, nede kayata. Palete kurete. Nete telite kayada. Maskende de boshanda. Oh, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Lord, I want to see you. I want to see you. I want to see you.
Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up. Shining in the light of your glory.
Come on, worship him.
As we sing, holy, 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 open the eyes, open the eyes of my heart, I want to see you,
hallelujah, Jesus,
I want to see you, open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart, I want to see you.
Hallelujah.
I want to see you.
Worship him, worship him. God bless you, Sister Rose. It is well with you in the name of Jesus. If you haven't already shared, please share and invite people. Share and invite people. Share and invite people to join. Highly lifted up, mask in the bush. Rababo send it. You know, YouTube. Hallelujah. Shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. High and lifted up. Shining in the light of your glory. Come on, worship him, worship him. Worship him. Share and invite your friends. Mask and the devotion, the Holy Ghost, we worship you. Lord, we worship you. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. We just worship you, Jesus. Holy, 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 Lord, we worship you. We sing holy. We sing holy. We sing holy. We sing holy. We want to sing holy. Lord, we sing holy. We want to see you. We want to see you. We want to see you. Manda da da bo shende de 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 de. Raga ba 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 skende de de bo shende. Rete po skende kulada ba yekeri daba. Masente kayata. Matelete kurete. Rende de de bo shende. Rende de de bo shende. Oh, we give you praise. We give you praise. We sing holy. We sing holy. Oh, Jesus, Jesus. Maskende de devotion, maskende de devotion, maskende de devotion, raba ba 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 ba, lende kuyada maskende de, lende de devotion, who de bolide kayata, maskende de devotion, Lord, we worship you this morning, oh, we worship you this evening, manda ga yekerite polete, Lord, we worship you, 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 maskende de devotion. Mask and the devotion, the da 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 da. Mask and the devotion, the ra da 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 da. Jesus, we worship you. Jesus, we worship you. Jesus, we worship you. Lord, we worship you. Mata kura da ba send the Holy Spirit, we adore you. Holy Spirit, we exalt you. Mata rete kulata. Mata rete kulata. Netete yete kurada. Irete posente lete kayada da 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 da. Masente kuraya balende de boshanda. Manda da da bosende de bosende de de de. Raka ba 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 ye ba ba. Lete kurata kuyete te. Maskende de boshanda. Raba ba 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 yende kulada bos. Maskende de boshende. Rende de bosende. Oh Jesus, 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 Jesus. You deserve all the praise. You deserve all the glory, all the honor, the adoration is yours, O God. Manda kayata. Lord, we just bless you. We bless you. Grace and mercy, Lord. 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 Matarete kurete. Nete lite kayata. Radarabos kendere de bosh. Rendere de bosh endere de bosh. Maskende de bosh andaha. Rete lite kayata. Masente kula. Nendere de bosh andada da 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 da. Rabababababas kendere de bosh. Randada da bosh endere de bosh. Oh Jesus, Jesus, we give you praise. You are worthy, you are worthy. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy. Hey, just magnify his name, magnify his name. Magnify his name, magnify his name, magnify his name. Magnify his name, magnify his name, lift his name on high, lift him on high, lift him on high, lift him on high. Lord, you are worthy. His grace is enough for us. 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 My shandarabo. Say, Lord, you are worthy. You are worthy. Your grace is enough for me. Your grace is all I need. Your grace is all I need. Your grace is enough for me, Jesus. Your grace is enough for me, Jesus. Your grace is enough for me, Father. Manda da da bo shende de de de. Your grace is enough. Masente kurada bo shende. Lord, I receive your grace. Lord, I receive your grace. Lord, I receive your grace. My God, I receive your grace. Landa bo shende de 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 de. Oh, hallelujah. Unchangeable God. Oh, mashende kura daba. Rente kulata kalata. Nendere bo shende de de. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough, Jesus. Your grace is enough. Your grace is all that we need. Lord, we desire your grace. Mashete kura tapa. Netete kurete. Netete kurete. Landa da bo shanta kuye. Masente kurada. Your grace is enough. Landa da bo shende. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Maskente kulata parete kayata. Rende de bo shanda. Your grace is enough for us. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Landa kayata. Landa kayata. Lord, we step into your grace. Begin to say, Lord, I step into your grace. I step into your grace. Father, I step into your grace. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Mashende de bo. Lete kurata palete. Maskende de bo shende. Randa da bo skende. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough, Jesus. Mata kurada bo shende de 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 de. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, Jesus. Masente kurada ba. Randa da bo shende de de. Lete kurada ba sente. Mata kurede bo shende. Jesus, we worship you. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. Maskende de bush. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Maskende de bush. Rada da da bosente kurada. Oh, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Masente kurada bosende. Lord, we worship you. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. Nende de de bosh, nende de de bosh. Nende de de bosh, nende de de bosh. Just give him praise, just give him praise. Just give him praise, just give him praise. Father, you are worthy. Lord, you are worthy. Jesus, you are worthy. Ancient of Days, you are worthy. Lion of the tribe of Judah, you are worthy. We just glorify your name. We just glorify your name. We just glorify your name. Masente kurada bosh shanda da da bosh nende de de bosh shende kuya maskende de de bosh shende. Oh Jesus, you are worthy. Jesus, you are worthy. Jesus, you are worthy. Masente kurada bosh mashanda da da bosh shende. Oh hallelujah, hallelujah Jesus, hallelujah Jesus, hallelujah Jesus. Just bless his name, bless his name. Just begin to appreciate him, begin to appreciate him. He's worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy. Him alone is worthy. Him alone is worthy. Him alone is worthy. You alone are worthy, Father. May your name be praised forever. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Mashendebos. 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 Rata palete. Kurada basente kuyendede. Maskendede boshandaha. May your name be praised forever. May your name be praised forever. May your name be praised forever. My shame, devils. Father, we bless you. 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 Just bless his name. Just bless his name. Just bless his name. Just bless him. Just bless him. Father, we worship you. We exalt you. We bless you. We glorify you. We magnify you. We say, may your name be praised forever. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. We bless you. We glorify you. We magnify you. May your name be praised forever. May your name be praised forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. Father, we just bless you. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. May your name be praised forever. May your name be praised forever. May your name be praised forever. Father, we thank you for this hour. We thank you for this hour. Holy Spirit, we invite you. We ask that you will take control. that you will teach us your word, that your name will be glorified, that your name will be praised. In the name of Jesus, we empty ourselves before you. 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 In the name of Jesus, we cover ourselves in your blood. Everyone in your blood. Everyone watching in your blood. We soak ourselves in your blood. We soak all we are going to hear, all we are going to do here in the blood. Your blood, your blood, the blood, the precious blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father. May your name be praised forever. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, everyone. You are all welcome in the mighty name of Jesus. We serve a faithful Father. We serve a faithful God. Hi, hallelujah. You are loved. We are loved by Him. Yes, Lord, teach us your words today. Holy Ghost, teach us your word. Teach us your word. Let it not be about any one of us, but you, O God. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. How many of you are excited? Our program is coming up. I'm going to be doing the poster very soon. We are going to be having our 3 days of supernatural encounter and deliverance. It's coming up. You know, it's monthly. So the one for this month is coming up on the 15th. Let me check the date. I've just been working out the date. It's coming up like in about 2 weeks from now. So the poster will be out. You are ready to fast 3 days. Ha ha ha. 3 days. 3 days of fasting. Hallelujah. How many of us are ready? Who is going to go dry? Who is going to do dry fast? You can do the fast that is convenient for you. You know, God is good. Glory to God. I know you can't wait, right? You can't wait for that program. It is a powerful program. Hour of encounter, hour of deliverance. Hey, the devil is in trouble. The devil is in trouble. You know, you guys know the last one, how God dealt with the devil. Look at the deliverance, all the deliverances. Look at everything that the Lord do. A whole lot of people were set free. Ha! Demons were leaving. They were checking out. Checking out. Back to where they came from. They could not stand the power of God. You are ready. Hey, Holy Ghost. Hey, your people are ready. Yo. We are ready. I am so ready. I will try it. You will try 7 days. You did 3 days. You were doing smoothies in the evening, right? Ha! How many of us will go 3 days dry? 3 days with liquids, 3 days with fruits, anyhow you want to do it, but fast. Make sure you fast. That yoke, that bond, every bondage, yoke of bondage, anything that the enemy has placed in our lives that is not of God, they are checking out. Even from now, they have started checking out. 3 days. I think the exact date is going to be on the 15th, so I'm going to talk to the ministers that will be ministering alongside me. Where is the paper I wrote the date on? I just want to be sure of the date, but I think it's in the middle of the month. It's going to be like from on the 15th, 15, 16, and 17, I think, or 16, 17, 18. Hallelujah. I can't wait. I can't wait to see what the Lord have in store for us. Hallelujah. You're going to catch motive. No, it's not me. God is going to catch multiple. God is going to catch them. All the thieves that came to steal, to kill and to destroy. All those thieves that does not want us to achieve. They do not want the plans and the purpose of God to materialize in our lives. They are checking out. They are checking out. They have no choice. They have to check out. Masente kurada bababa shende. They have to check out in the name of Jesus. The Holy Ghost is going to catch all of them and chase them out. Back to where they come from, whether from the marine. That one says it's from the junction. Remember that one, the masquerade that said it's from the junction. They will check back to wherever they come from in the name of Jesus. So just get ready. I can see you guys are already excited. It was powerful. I know the last one was powerful. But this one is going to be even more powerful. So start praying from now. Start praying from now. Start praying from now. Hallelujah. By this time, next 2 weeks, we'll be rounding up, you know. So I can't wait to see what the Lord have in store for us in these 3 days of supernatural encounter and deliverance with fasting. So get ready to fast too. Get ready to do your 3 days fasting anyhow you want it, dry, with water, with drinks, not sugary drinks, so just only liquid is only the only liquid allowed is water, tea and coffee. And then you can, like one sister, she was using smoothies for the 3 days, once a day in the evening she will break with smoothies, 6 to 6. You can do 6 to 6. You can do the 3 days dry. You can do the 3 days with whatever, but make sure make sure you do something. Make sure you participate. Those doors you have been knocking on, that the devil is still standing and telling you, it is not possible. It is not possible. You are going to beat the devil to his game. Knock him on the head and the Lord is going to push him out of your way. Those doors will be opened in the name of Jesus. It's going to be an hour or 3 days of real, real, real encounter by the grace of God. I know, I believe God that it is going to be great. It is going to be great. So get ready for that. And in June, towards the end of June, we are going to be having 7 days of glory. You know, that program used to be monthly last year. But this year, because of, you know, God is just rearranging everything for us. So the supernatural encounter, it's monthly now. So it's 3 days in the month. But 7 days of glory will be in June after the ones May. We are now in May, April, May, June. It's going to be next month. It's going to be 7 days of glory. That is the title, the theme for that 7 days. So we are going to be fasting for 7 days. God is already frustrating the devil. God is already frustrating the devil in the name of Jesus. How many of you can fast for 7 days? It's not dry. We can do 6 to 6 for 7 days. Just 7 days of supernatural encounter. all of you that the devil is tying your husband somewhere. Divine location. Your husbands will be released to you. Your children, you've been married. You've been trusting God. Hey, in those times, your wombs will open and you will receive your children. Those of you that the enemy stole your businesses, your jobs, your blessings, miracles, testimonies, your health, every good thing that the Lord has given to you, they have no choice but to vomit it. They are going to be vomiting everything they have stolen from your life in the name of Jesus. We trust the Lord. We trust the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, I'm just warming you up. Just be warming up. Just be warming up. Just be warming up. We are warming up. Just be warming up. Get ready. 3 days. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord will give us grace. We will do it, and the devil will be put to shame. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. How many of you are happy? I am so happy. I am so happy. I am so happy. Because I trust my God. I know the God that I serve. I know the God that I serve. He has never failed and he will not start now. Glory to you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. If you haven't shared this video, please do share. Share it and invite people. Share. Invite your friends. Invite your families to watch. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It is well with us in the name of Jesus. And also be praying for the conference. You know, we told you we are having 4 conferences coming up in different locations. On your mark. We are ready. Ready to run. Hallelujah. These 4 conferences are coming up. They are coming up. The devil is in serious trouble. Hallelujah. The 4 conferences in different locations in Nigeria is coming up. And you guys, you know, right? You need to start sowing into that conference. You need to start sowing. You need to start putting your seed there. You need to start showing your support and be praying for souls. The aim and objective of these conferences, of these programs, is for soul winning. Soul winning. God loves it. Angels in heaven rejoices over one soul that repents. Hallelujah. So God is passionate about soul. We too, as his children, we need to be passionate about soul. That is the reason you are seeing my PayPal there. If you are begin to sow into that conference, begin to sow. 4 conferences in different locations, in different cities. Then there is women empowerment alongside it, alongside the conference. And then we are having, this time around, we are going to be having prison ministrations. We are going to be going to prison. We are going to be taking, we are buying like 200 Bibles. We are going to buy 200 Bibles. We are going to visit a prison in Benin City, then the prison in Lagos. And then the orphanage, we are going to take the children in one of the orphanage out for the day. I don't know where we are going to take them yet. We're just going to shatter this coastal. We're just going to hire a bus or buses. Take all the children in that orphanage out. Nobody takes them out. Just take them out somewhere nice, maybe to the zoo. Maybe some of them haven't even been to the zoo. Is there a zoo in Nigeria, sir? I don't know. If there is no zoo, we take them somewhere for picnic. We take them somewhere for picnic, cook them food, or we can cook them coolers of food, chicken, rice, buy them drinks, or we can take them to a restaurant. They will just order what they want to eat and we will pay for it. This is the project. This is what we have. And the budget is £10,000. I am not afraid. I am not shaking. Because I know my God that gives the vision, he will provide. If God is laying it in your heart to support the conference, the posters will be out very soon for the 4 conferences and the women empowerment, where we train women. God bless you, Deborah. We train the women. We teach them to do something so that they can be useful to themselves and be useful to the society. Gone are the days when women will just sit down and fold their arms and sit in the house. This ministry is not about that. We're going to sow into their lives. We bless the widows. The widows that will attend that program, my God, we want to do something big, major, to encourage them. God says he's the husband of the widow. If God is the husband of the widow, we are relatives. God is our father. We are relatives of the widows. So we too need to sow into their lives. That is what God wants us to do. Sow to the poor and the needy. As you do this, God will bless you. Nothing is too big. Nothing is too small. Whatever the Lord lays in your heart to support this vision, to support these conferences, to support this mission, please. If you click on this thing, the pinned post there is a Nigerian account number there too. Some people were asking me for Nigerian account number because you find it easier to pay to Nigeria direct. So the Nigerian account number is underneath that PayPal, I think so. Or I hope so. Rabo Shenere, God will bless you for supporting his work and his ministry in the name of Jesus. We have been treating the book of John. Hallelujah. How many of you are being blessed with the book of John series? The book of John series. You need the account number. Click the pinned post. I think it's there. Sister Tani, did you post it? I've not checked the pinned post if the Nigeria account is there. Nigeria account is there. Let me check it. She'll be on the pinned post. If not, she will have to repost it. Yes, it's there. Zenith Bank. Click on the pinned post, Eva. Click on the pinned post. Yes, the Nigeria account number is there. Click on that pinned post. Underneath this PayPal, there is a Nigerian account number. There's a Nigeria account number. Let me see if I can post it separately too. But even if I post it, okay, you saw it now. Okay, I saw now. Okay. When you click the pinned post, there is a Nigerian account number. I think it's Zenith Bank. Zenith Bank. Account number is there. And the name is there. That is all the information you need. Okay, you saw it. God bless you. How many of you have been blessed with the Book of John series? It's been awesome. We are on John chapter 10 now. We are on John chapter 10 now. How many of you have been blessed with it? We are just going to continue. We did chapter 9 yesterday. It was powerful. You know how people, they don't rejoice when good thing is happening to somebody. They'll begin to question. In John chapter 9, I'm just recapping. We saw the John chapter 9 was talking about, he's talking about the story of this blind man that was born blind. And Jesus was passing his way. And he got healed. And people begin to question his healing. People begin to parade the man. They began to interrogate his parents. How come? How did your son get healed? Did you say he was born blind? Have they not seen that man that he's been blind? That is the life that we are. When good things are happening to us, when God is blessing you, the first people to question you are your families, your friends, people you call your own. They can't understand why you should be the one that is being blessed. Why not them? Why not them? But there is enough room, space for everybody. God is ever faithful. That man was faithful. He had faith. The man believed God. When God put the mud in his eyes and said, go and wash yourself, he did not argue. He did not argue with Jesus. He just left. He went and he washed his eyes in the pool. And instantly, he got his healing. What is God instructing you to do? That you are dragging. You are fighting with him. You are dragging with him. You don't want to do it. There is blessing in obedience. There is blessing in obedience. There is blessing in obedience. Listen to the voice of God. See what they did to the man. They chased him out of the synagogue. They drove him out of the church only because he was blessed. And because he was defending his healing. He knew who had blessed him. And he was defending his healing. And because of that, they chased him out. But thank God for Jesus. Why he was chased out. Why he was rejected. That is rejection. He was rejected. He was abandoned. Ostracized. But Jesus went looking for him. The Bible says Jesus found him. That is how precious we are to God. That is how precious you are to God. That is how important we are to God. When Jesus heard that this man that he healed has been driven out of the temple, has been driven out of the synagogue, which is a church, he went looking for him. And he found him. And this time around, he brought him to Christ. He brought him to himself. This man got saved. He got born again. Do you know sometimes people chasing you, they do not know that they are chasing you into your destiny. And they will think they are doing you wickedness. Probably you are living with somebody. You came to Europe. Normal. When you come to Europe the first time, you need accommodation. You are staying. Somebody say, oh, come and stay with me. And then you stay. And they began to see the way things are going with you. They get jealous. They will tell you, leave my house. Leave my house. And then you begin to get worried. Hey, where will I go? And suddenly, the Lord gives you a much better accommodation. Where you have your peace. Where you have your peace. The Lord gives you a much better one. And they drive you out of that job. And you think that the end is here. Oh, the end has come. Suddenly, the Lord opens to you another door. Hey, and you get even a better job, better than that one that you were driven out of. Even the pay is better. Sometimes people you call your friend, they are the one pushing you, driving you. Oh, they think they are doing you wickedness. They think they are crucifying you. But they are pushing you into your destiny. How many of you have witnessed that? How many of you have witnessed something like that? Where they think, oh, they are being wicked to you. They are being mean to you. Rest of my... But unknown to them, they push you into your glory. They push you into your destiny. They push you into the promises of God. And when they look at how God is blessing you, they begin to regret, oh, why did I even drive him? Why did I even drive her? Yes, it has to happen so that we can launch, so that we can move ahead. So that we can step into the promises of God. So that we can step into the blessings of God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hey. Hallelujah. Hey, do you know that is a fact? They think they are chasing you. They are disturbing your life. They are chasing you. They don't want you to have peace. And they chase you into your destiny. They chase you into the plans of God for your life. God is ever faithful. He never fails those that put their trust in him. He never disappoints those that put their trust in him. He is a faithful father. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Just shout hallelujah. 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 Shout hallelujah if you believe that. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Mas kendebo shandaha. Glory to God. I say shout hallelujah if you believe that. Hallelujah. Masking the devil. Janice is saying, let me try to read your comment from here. Masking the devil. Shanda. Let me see. It says, I experienced it, evangelist. Patience. God is awesome. He turns everything around for us because we trust and love him so Love him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That is what I'm talking about. That is it. That is it. They think they are being wicked and mean, but they push you into your destiny. They push you into the plans of God. They push you into the purpose of God for your life. So that is why you should not be discouraged when things are not working the way you want them to work. You are trying to go on the right, and the thing is pushing you, situations, circumstances, people, your environment is pushing you to the right. Don't worry. Just flow, because God has a plan. You know, when God says that the steps of the righteous are ordered by him, that is it. Our steps, if you are righteous, if you are the righteousness of God, if you are righteous, you trust him, you believe him, he orders your step. He orders your step. Sometimes something might need to happen for you to be pushed into that place. Hallelujah. But God is ever faithful. One thing I know for sure is that we are never alone. He never leaves us. We are never abandoned. He is ever faithful. Glory to God. I love him so much. How many of you love him? Do you love the Lord? If you love him, just say, Lord, I love you. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Begin to say it. I love you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, for your faithfulness, for your grace, for your mercies, for your goodness. I love you, Jesus. I just love you. I just love you. I just love you. Lord, I love you. I love you, Father. Come on, say something nice to him. Say something nice to him as we continue. Come on, type. Type it. What is it? Type it. Say something. Say something. I love you, Father. I love you, Father. I love you, my God. Hey, my shanda bo sende gede bo shanda ha. Rata palete kuyete kurada bo shende he. Ma sende de bo. Yes, I love you, Jesus. You are my God. You are my strength. You are my strong tower, my provider, lover of my soul. I just love you. I just love you. Come on, express your heart to him right now. Oh, my shanda bo sende kayata. Oh, rete bolite kayata ba sende he. Lord, you deserve all the glory. You deserve all the honor. You deserve all the worship. Mas kende bo shanda ha. Rada da da bo sende ku rada da da bo shende he. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord Jesus. Rete kuyataba. Rete kuyataba. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, this makes God happy. When you tell him how much you love him. When you tell him how much you love him. How much you appreciate him. How much. How much. How much. How much you acknowledge it. It makes him happy. It makes our Father happy. Oh, glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Ma sente kurata. Nete kulada bo shendehe. Rada baba sente kalata lete kuyete. Thank you, Jesus. We are grateful to you. We are grateful to you. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Heaven is rejoicing right now. Heaven is happy right now. Heaven is pleased with us right now. Glory to God. Thank you, Jehovah God. We give it to you. May your name be praised forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You deserve all the honor. Yes, Lord. You deserve all the glory. Yes, Lord. Keep it coming. You deserve all the praise. Yes, Lord. Ha. All adoration is yours. Yes, Lord. All the worship is yours. Hallelujah. Ma sente kurata. Take it, Father. We give it to you. We just give it to you. We just give it to you. We love you, Father. For whom you are, we love you. You are so good. You are so good. You are awesome. Oh, Jesus, take all the glory. Take it, Father. Take it, Father. We give it to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. And so we are moving on to the book of John chapter 10. We are on chapter 10 today. It's talking about the shepherd and his sheep. Who is the shepherd? Who are the sheep? Maskendebo. Yes, he's good all the time, Garcia. Yes, he deserves it. Hallelujah. The shepherd and the sheep. He's our master. Hallelujah. Wow, you guys are in the mood for worship right now. His love endures forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We magnify you, Jesus. Glory to God. Yes, 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 yes. Hallelujah. Let's continue. Maybe at the end of this teaching, we'll worship him briefly. Let us see this. John chapter 10. Somebody type John chapter 10. We can do verse 1 to... How many is F? Let's do verse 1 to 21. Someone type for me. John chapter 10, verses 1 to 21. Let's read 1 to 21. John chapter 10, verses 1 to 21. Can you type it, please? Where are my assistants? My able typist. God bless you all. I love you guys, right? You know that. You know I love you. John chapter 10, verses 1 to 21 is where we are reading from. Glory to God. I'm waiting to see. Yeah, that is it. God bless you. That is it. Hallelujah. God bless you all. I can trust you, you know. Hallelujah. God bless you all. God bless you all. John chapter 10, verses 1 to 21. And so get your Bibles and let's read. I'm reading from the easy to read version. God bless you, Deborah. You are, it is well with you in Jesus' name. Maru, God bless you all for typing. God bless you all. Jesus said, it is certainly true that when a man enters the sheep pen, which is the sheep quarters where the sheep are kept, he should use the gate. He should use the gate. If he climbs in some other way, he's a robber. He's trying to steal the sheep. But the man who takes care of the sheep enters through the gate. He is the shepherd. The man who guards the gate opens the gate for the shepherd. And the sheep listen to the voice of the shepherd. He calls his own sheep using their names, and he leads them out. He brings all of his sheep out. Then he goes ahead of them and leads them. The sheep follow him because they know his voice. But he said, but sheep will never follow someone they don't know. Do you know that about sheep? They will not follow someone they don't know. They will run away from him because they don't know his voice. Jesus told the people this story, but they did not understand what it meant. Hallelujah. Jesus is talking. He was speaking in parable. The sheep and the shepherd. Who is the sheep? Who are the shepherds? Who are the sheep? Who is the shepherd? Jesus is talking about himself. He's talking about you and I, the Christians of today, the supposed children of God today. Our God is the sheep, is the shepherd. We are his sheep. We are his sheep. But he says, my sheep, his sheep hears his voice and they follow him. They follow him. How many sheep are in the house today? How many of us are genuinely following Jesus? How many of us knows and recognizes his voice? He was speaking a parable to them. When you climb the gates, anyone that wants to go into the sheep den, anyone that wants to come to Christ, you are using shortcut. You are climbing over the gates. Instead of you to go through the gates, open the gates and go straight in. Some people, they like shortcuts. They are jumping the fence. They are jumping the fence. This one, the Bible says they are thieves. Bible says they are robbers. They are criminals. They do not belong to him. Oh, they are here to steal the sheep. How many wolves do we have today on this planet Earth that are climbing the fence? They are hiding under the name of Christ. They are stealing the sheep of God, but they will steal only those that will allow themselves to be stolen. Many false prophets have risen. They call the name of Christ, but they are using demonic powers. They are using demonic powers. They are doing things that are not biblical. They are doing things that are not scriptural. They climb the fence because they want to steal the sheep of God. And I pray for you that you will never be deceived. May you never be stolen in the name of Jesus. That is why, as a sheep of God, you need to know whom you are. You need to know yourself. You need to know whom you are. How be it in this time? You see videos of some pastors that are caught. They are burying human life as a foundation for their churches. Many of them. I was watching a video of a man in Nigeria that was caught. He killed his girlfriend. He did not know. He was lured by one. He said he's the head of this spiritual church, garment church, whatever church it is that they belong to. And he was initiated. And they told him that he has to do a sacrifice. And so for them to do the sacrifice, he has to bring somebody. He has to bring somebody. He has to give somebody a human life in exchange. Can you see how foolish and stupid the devil is? How deceptive that devil is. And he gave them his girlfriend. And they killed the girl in the church, inside a supposed church, demonic altars. I saw this on video. They caught him and he was confessing on video. I don't know who sent it to me a while ago. He was saying that he didn't know, he was misled, that he was told to bring, and he brought this person. And they killed this girl. And they were not able to get rid of the blood and everything by the morning. And that is how they caught them. And they saw the remains of this girl in that church. And this is the same kind of church people will go. They are the ones that will blow breeze like this. Everybody will fall down. They will blow breeze because they have gone to the kingdom of darkness to collect power. They have initiated themselves. And they will initiate all the members of that church. That is why I always tell you, my brethren, that is why I always encourage you, read your Bible. Draw close to God so that you will not be carried away. And you know people that are easily carried away, miracle seekers. Speak into my life. Tell me something about my life. They are the miracle seekers. They are looking for a place where instant miracle will happen. They are the one running and seeking miracle instead of seeking Christ, instead of running to Christ. My God. Seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, everything will be added unto you. All you need, that is why, look at all of you that got your deliverance. When you come, the first thing I say, is for you to be born again. It's for you to accept Christ, because it is Christ that will do it. It is Christ that will come to your head. It is Christ, only him that can help you. I cannot help you. No pastor, nobody can help you. It is only God that can help us. No man can help us. Yes, we are instruments. He can use us. But he is still the one doing it. He only uses us as instruments to answer prayers. Because he cannot physically come. You cannot see him physically. And so he's raised up servants to use. But you need to have the gift of designing. You need to learn to design. You need to pray for spiritual sight. So that when you come before these people. But look at what God called it. Jesus is referring to them as robbers, as thieves. I did not say it. Microwave Christians, shortcuts microwave Christians. That is correct, my sister. That is right. I call them microwave Christians, 2 minute Christians. They just want instant solution. They want it now. They want to buy a car now. How can you say I should pray for you to buy a car when you don't have a job? The first prayer is for you to get a good job. And then you get wages. And then from your wages, you buy your car. You want a miracle car. Are you going to go to the dealers and steal a car? How are you going to get a car without money? You need money, except you want to go and steal one. But people will come, speak into my life. It's those people, they get carried away. Speak into my life, and I will look at you now, and I'll begin to speak what God have not sent me to say. And then I begin to speak fear into you. I begin to speak misery into you. Hey. And then you begin to run helter skelter. And after speaking this fear and misery, I will tell you, don't worry. Just bring money. Let us do sacrifice. Just bring money. I will go to the mountain. And then you go, how much? 100,000. A sister watching from Canada. She said a man told her to come and sow. Was it 10,000? Was it 1,000 or 2,000? I can't remember. Sister Anne. I don't think she's online. If she's online, she will confirm how much she said. And she said, she told the man, I don't have, I'm not working. The man said, okay, don't worry. Just sell anything you have for now, and then you can pay the rest later. For what? Eh? You will now sell what you don't have. Then you'll be owing him credit. For what? Is that what the Lord wants us to do? If you do not know God, you'll be easily misled, because they will prophesy. It's not prophecy you are looking for. Prophecy of doom. That's all that will come out of them. Doom, doom, doom. But you too, Nana, that is all you are running after. Miracle seekers. You are running after miracles. where you are a prophet unto your own self. Hey, the truth you know is what is going to set you free. We read that in the previous chapter. You need to know the truth of God for yourself. As I am here, if I am saying something that is not in the Bible, you will be able to know, because you know that is not what is in the Bible. But whereby you don't know the Bible, whereby you don't even know what God is saying about you in the Bible, whereby you don't know the authority that you carry in the Bible, you begin to run to them. All these prophets of doom, fake pastors, fake ministers of God. Look at them. They are here. The Bible says they jump, they come through the window. They jump through the fence. They jump through the fence. And you give them your head to lay hands on. And they begin to impact demons into you. They begin to send demons and evil spirits into you. Before they lay hands on you, you can sleep peacefully in the night. From that time they lay hands on you, you can't sleep anymore. You are being tormented in your dreams. Masquerades begin to chase you. Demons begin to chase you. Shebi, when they chase you, you too, you will run to them, isn't it? You will run to them now. You will run to them. Instead of you to run to Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. That is why God is encouraging you and I that we should draw near to him so that he will also draw near to us. When you draw near to God, God will draw near to you. He has given you power. The power that any man of God has. The power that any woman of God have. You have it. If you have Jesus, if you are genuinely born again, you have it. You have it. Look at what he said. It's not me. It's in John 10 from verse 1. It says true that when a man enters the sheep pen, the household of sheep, where they keep them, he should use the gate, enter through the gate. He shouldn't be looking for coin. If he climbs in some other way, he is a robber. And that is what the devil is after. To steal as many as he can from the body of Christ. To lead as many as he can to hell. I pray that we will not be victims in the name of Jesus. At all. Yes, so he that does not work, you are looking for miracle money. You are looking for a miracle job. It will happen when you are trusting God. It depends on the scenario. Miracle money can come when there is a need for it. But not that you are lazy. You are not working. You are not doing anything. You are waiting for miracle money. You are waiting for miracle this, miracle that. Eh? God does not work like that. God hates laziness. God hates lazy people. And that is why you begin to fall victim to these people. That is why your life is an open book before the kingdom of darkness. There is a sister here that shared her testimony. She lost her job. She's working. She's very hardworking. She lost her job some time ago. And she did not have any job anymore. Last week, we were praying in the group. She was saying she don't even have money to pay her rent and her bills. And she's a single mom with two children. With two children. No money to pay rent. She's looking for a job. The job has not come. Yesterday, she was sharing to me. Sharing her testimony. God provided for her supernaturally. She doesn't even know how the money came. She was saying, I don't even know how the money came. She has paid her rent of £550. She has paid her bills and she is still feeding. Isn't that God? That is what we are talking about. Not that she's being lazy. She was looking for a job. She lost her job. But such a thing, God will give her miracle money. God will take care of her. God will take care of you too. He sees your heart. See the way God supernaturally provided for her. She shared her testimony. It's on my messenger. I will share it later. God provided, she paid her rent. She says she does not know how God provided that miracle money. She just saw that she had enough money to pay her rent and to pay her bills. That is how powerful God is. While she's looking for a job, God is taking care of her. Not that you don't want to work. You are not so lazy. You don't even want, you are here, social welfare. You are sitting on social welfare. You don't want to work and you want God to bless you. You are looking for miracle money. You tie down your own destiny. You cannot even access a loan. Ha, shendebo sanda kayata. Look at what Jesus is saying. All those ones coming through the fence, instead of them to come through the door, they are thieves. They are robbers. Stealing what belongs to God. What belongs to God? God says, come through the gate. Come through the gate. Eh? He says, my sheep. Verse 4. Say he brings, the shepherd goes into where his sheep are. He brings all his sheep out. Then he goes ahead of them and leads them. Now look at this. He goes ahead of them and he leads them. The sheep does not go ahead of the shepherd. The shepherd goes ahead of the sheep and the shepherd leads the sheep. Who is leading you? Who is your shepherd? Who is the shepherd? No food for lazy people. Yes, so who is your shepherd? Look at what he says. He says, he calls his own sheep. He calls his own sheep using their names. Can you see that? Using their names. So do you know how important you are? How valuable you are? God knows your name. He said, even the hair. Look at my natural hair. This is my natural hair. It's very short. It's growing though. Look at my hair. He knows it. Every single strand of hair. Look at that. This is one. This is even more than one strand I'm holding. Every single strand. Every single strand. Look. It is numbered. On my hair. My hair on my head. Each one is numbered. He says he knows their name. Not he calls them by their name. Shanta kulete kurata pasente. Maskende bo shanda dada. Radabose. See that? Do you see that? That is from verse 3. He says, and the sheep listen to the voice of the shepherd. The sheep listen to the voice of the shepherd. Who is your shepherd? Are you a good sheep? Are you a sheep? Or a wolf? Am I a sheep? Or a wolf? Do we listen to the voice of the shepherd? Or we are just doing our own things? We just do things. We live our life anyhow. We live our life anyhow we want to live it. We don't give a hoot. We don't care. You forget. We forget that there is one taking record in heaven. We forget that heaven is recording everything we do here on earth. That is why the Bible says on that day, we will go and give account of how we have lived our lives on earth. That is why we should not be careless. That is why we should be careful. Say the sheep, they hear his voice and they follow him. Are you a follower of Christ? Are you a sheep that is obedient to the shepherd? Are you a sheep that is following that shepherd? Are you a sheep that hears his voice and follow? Or you are that one that is stubborn? You are that one that is refusing to surrender? You are that one that is saying, Lord, I am not ready. Or you are that one that says, Lord, just hold on, I am coming. God wants all his sheep to hear him. He wants them to hear him. He wants us to hear him. I am interested. They say he calls his own sheep using their names. Many of you, God has called you into ministry. He has called you. He has called you to write books. You just sit down and then you begin to hear, you know, God is saying he's giving you topics upon topics to go write books. But you are refusing to step into it. You are refusing to acknowledge that gift. You are refusing to listen. You are refusing to follow. You are here. God is calling you. He's called into women ministry. He's called into men ministry. He's called into children ministry. He's called you here. And you are still being disobedient. You are still saying, Lord, not yet. Lord, not yet. And God is saying, it is now. God called me since 2007. He told me since 2007 that he has called me to be an evangelist. And then I begin to look at myself. Lord, I'm not qualified. Lord, I cannot do this. Lord, later, you know. And then we begin to go through over the years. 2007. It was not until last year that I stepped into my calling. He has told, used ministers of God to tell me whom. And when they tell me, I know. I say, yes, he already told me. Yes, he already told me. But what was stopping me from answering that call? Sometimes it's got to do with timing. Hallelujah. But God is calling you and he's telling you the time is now. If I was looking at my own ability, if I was looking at my own strength, you guys would not have known me. Look at the deliverance the Lord did in the lives of many of you in our last program. You would still be there. You've been like this for years. God, see, God has so planned it that it is through this platform you will get your deliverance. It is through this platform that you get healed. It is through this platform that you will get your salvation. But if I had not listened, what would have happened? I know he will make other ways. He will. But you need to stop looking at your own ability. By strength shall no man prevail. God is not looking for the swift. He's not looking for the most educated ones. He's not looking for those that can speak grammar. The kingdom of God is not about grammar. It's about the Bible. It's about the Holy Ghost. You will see people that did not go to the four corners of any school. When they are Holy Ghost filled, they will read like they are university graduates. Don't look at yourself and say, I'm not qualified. Don't look at yourself and begin to run. When God calls you, it is for a purpose. See, sometimes you might be tested. God might test your calling if you are ready. I started preaching on Facebook last year. But the giftings that the Lord has gifted me today wasn't there last year. That is the truth. And then the Lord said, led me to go to a conference this year. We did the same conference we are doing again next year. We did it this year, the first one. It was in that conference that God anointed me. He did not anoint me before the conference. You might be thinking, oh, which gifting am I going to use to operate in this area of my calling? And you are worried. You are scared. Don't be scared. When Jesus is calling you, he will make a way. He will make provision. My sheep hears my voice and they follow. When God was saying to us, go do this conference. The first thing I said to my husband, where are we going to get the money from? My husband said, God will provide. When he gives a vision, he makes provision. When God gives a vision, he makes provision. That is why we trusted him. We stepped out. Some of you supported with a few. Some of you supported to about £200, £204. But we spent way more than that. And the Lord really provided. Now he's leading me again to go bigger. And I am not afraid. £10,000? Wow. But he said, go bigger. And I am just obeying. My sheep hears my voice. How is that finance going to come? I don't know. And I'm not thinking about it. I am not. I am sleeping. See, I sleep very peacefully. Why? It's his work. It is his work. He will provide everything we need for that conference to be a success. For us to visit the prisoners. For us to visit the orphanages. For us to do the women empowerment. He will provide it. I am not shaking. I am not moved. I am not afraid. Because when he gives a vision, he makes provision. His sheep hears his voice and they follow. God has been calling you. You know it that you have this call. You know, you already see it. Some of you are called to be prophetess. You are called to be prophets. You are called to be evangelists. You are called into one ministry or the other, but you are scared. I am here to encourage you. Don't be afraid. All you need to do is to step in. When you step in, God will step in. When you step out, God will step in. You need to step out in faith. I stepped out in faith. February this year, I stepped out in faith. I went home. We did two conferences. One in Nigeria, one in Benin City, one in Ekpe, Lagos. And this one is that it has increased to four conferences in different cities. We are stepping out. And when you step out, there will be increase. God steps in. Today, look, you say you are praying and we are casting demons. We are doing this one. It did not happen last year. God withheld this gift from me until I said, yes, Lord. Until he tested me. He saw that I was ready. It was in that conference that he anointed me. So don't worry. God is leading you into anything. Ministry, don't be afraid. He's telling you to write these books. Don't be afraid. He's telling you he's put you in the children ministry or youth ministry. Don't be afraid. Step out. Step out. Because when you step out, God will step in. When you step out, God will step in. The Holy Ghost will step in. He will guide you. He will direct you. He will build you up. He's not looking for those ones that are overqualified. He's just looking for who is ready. All he wants is availability. All he wants to see is that we say, Lord, I am ready for whatever you want to do. I am ready, Lord. My sheep, they hear my voice and they follow. Hey, they follow. Look at this. He leads them out. He calls them by their own name. God knows your name and he's calling you by your name. He brings them all. He brings verse 4. He brings all of his sheep out. Then he goes ahead of them. Now look at that. He will not bring his sheep out and abandon them. God cannot bring you out and abandon you. He will not bring his sheep out and abandon them and leave them there. Oh, you are on your own. God will never leave us on our own. When you step out, God will step in. That's right. That is very correct. All you need to do is to step out first and watch him step in. Because he did it to me, so I know by experience. It was not until I stepped out that the Holy Ghost stepped in. He says, only sheep, he called them out. He said, then he goes ahead of them and leads them. Do you see that? Do you see that? Do you get it? He leads them. He goes ahead of them. The shepherd, look at the shepherd and the sheep. Picture a shepherd with his sheep. The shepherd is always in the front and the sheep, they follow. That is why you do not need to run ahead of God. When God is telling you to wait, be patient. Some of you, we are in so much haste. We are in so much hurry. We are in so much haste to get married. We are in so much haste to do this. We are in so much haste. And God is telling you, wait. Wait. So that you will not make any mistake. Wait. Even in ministry, I waited for years. I was patient for years. And when I felt that the time is now, I stepped out. God is saying, yes, this is what I've called it to be. All these years, since 2017, last year, he was training me. I was going through so many things. In ministry, I was being stabbed. In ministry, I was being... A lot of things happened between this space of time. But he was training me for the future. That is why when you come to me for counseling, I know just the right words to say by the power of the Holy Ghost. Because he's taking me through that lane. I have been through what you are going through now. I have been through what you are going through now. See, the best person to counsel you. Rabababa shende kulataka yete basende. Matatarete balete kusente. God bless you, Sister Bendu. I just saw your alert. Mashende kuradabos. God will never abandon you. God will never abandon your own. Hey, be patient. He is the one leading. You know, some of us, we are the one in charge. We are the one in control. We are the one sitting on the driver's seat of our car. While Christ is sitting on the passenger seat, you will miss it. You will miss your way. You will miss your way. You will miss it. You are the one to be on the passenger seat. And let God be on the driver's seat. Let God be the one controlling the steering of your life. Let God be the one leading you. Let him be the one guiding you. Don't jump into anything God is not asking you to do. Don't run ahead of him. He says his sheep. He brings them out. And he leads them. He guides them. No way. He will never abandon you. He will never abandon us. He guides them. He leads them. But the thing is that some of us, we are so much in a rush. We are so much in a hurry. We are so much in a hurry. We are no longer waiting to hear his voice. We are no longer waiting to hear what he's saying we should do. And that is why we miss it. God have not told you to come abroad. Wait. You are jumping. By fire, by force, you must come to Europe. And when you come to Europe, you get frustrated. When you come to Europe, you are running from pillar to post. When you come to Europe, nothing good is working. Because of wrong timing. God is saying, hold on. I will bless you with this. I will bless you with that. I will bless you with a good job. I will bless you with this and that. And then we begin to look for shortcuts. We begin to look to shortcut. Some of you begin to visit those herbalists. You begin to visit those spiritual homes that are supposedly to be working for God. Some of you will take yourself to spiritual churches. They will take you to the river. They will go and bait you in the river. That night, they unleash demons on you. Foul spirits on you. Mermaids on you. From that night, your life is no longer the same. Because you are running ahead of God. God bless you. You are watching from the U.S. It is well with you in the name of Jesus, Salma Ba. You are welcome in Jesus' name. My sheep, they hear my voice and they follow. Are you a follower of Christ? Are you following the shepherd, the good shepherd that will never lead you astray? Man will lead you astray. Man will fail you big time. Man will disappoint you big time. Oh, masking the boy, shanda da da da. But Jesus is the only way. That can never fail. That can never disappoint us. Jesus. He says he leads his sheep. He leads them to green pasture. He leads his sheep because they hear his voice, because they follow, and he, God, begins to guide them. Is the Lord the one guiding you today? Is he the one leading you today? Is he the one showing you the way to go? Hallelujah. Confirmation. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hear him. Listen to him. Because he will never lead you wrong. He will never lead you astray. Hey. Oh my God, my God. I don't know if we are catching it. If you are understanding me, say yes. Say, I understand. I understand. Let me see. Confirm. Or just be clicking the like button. Be clicking the like button. Let me see that you understand what I'm saying. That you are following me. Oh, Jesus. Rata pos kende. Do you see this? Click, press your like button if you are following, if you are understanding me. Or you want me to explain again, let me know. It's a Bible study. Rata posh. It's a Bible study. There's no rush. Wherever we stop today, we stop. We continue tomorrow. That is it. Anywhere we stop, we stop. We are not going to rush it. We're just going to take our time to study this word. Hallelujah. You understand it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Masente kurata. Netete kurete posente. Say he brings them out. Verse 4. And he leads them. Say the sheep follow him because they know his voice. But sheep will never follow someone they don't know. They will run away from him because they don't know his voice. Jesus told the people he told this story, but they refused. They were not understanding. They still were not understanding. God bless you, sir. God bless you. Thank you, Father God. Look at that. Whose voice do you hear? If you are a sheep, you will hear the voice of the shepherd. You will follow, and then you will stay back and let him guide and let you lead. You are praying for a life partner. You are praying for a life partner, and you like this. You like them tall, handsome. You like them, and God is showing you your husband to be a short man, and you want a tall man. But God is saying, that tall man is not giving you peace. This is the one I have chosen for you. And they begin to say, this cannot be God. This cannot be God. This cannot be God. And then you run ahead of God. You will tell God, God, I know this is not it. You see, some people, they begin to bind and cast. Begin to bind and cast the devil. Whereas God is the one speaking. God is the one speaking. And then we go into disobedience. This one is not tall enough. He's not beautiful, handsome enough. She's not tall enough. She's not handsome and beautiful enough. This one, that one. And then before you know it, you abandon that one because it's not qualified. You run after that one that God is saying is not yours. That one that God is saying, that is not my choice for you. You begin to run after that one because he's tall, he's handsome. Ooh, you'll be so proud to introduce him to your friends, to your family, to anybody. And then you begin to run ahead of God. And then you rush yourself into that marriage. Ha! You rush, and this brother comes and pretends to be a Christian. The moment he got you married, hey, calamity, trouble. You begin to pray hot prayer. I tell my guests on my prayer team, I can't pray hot prayer out. Listen very well that I know that God is the one speaking to you. Start praying hot prayer. You begin to contract pastors to pray. You begin to stress us when you are living in disobedience. When you lived in disobedience. When you ran ahead of God. Before 3 years, the marriage is over. You are back to square one. Where you started. Where you started. You are back to square one. Back to square one where you started. All because of disobedience. My sheep hears my voice and they follow. Masente kurata kayata. If you haven't shared this video, this broadcast, please do so. Invite people. Be a blessing to people. When you see a good message, not just from me alone, from anywhere, any platform, you know this message, the Holy Ghost convicts you that this is true word of God. Share it and be a blessing to people. You'll be saving lives you may not know. Glory to God. Glory to God. My sheep hears my voice. In anything, you need to be sensitive to the voice of God. You need to be sensitive to the voice of God so that you will not fall victim. Hey, my shanda darabo sente kurata kalata. So that you will not be crying later. And before you know it, it stops you from praying. Before you know it, it stops you from going to church. Before you know it, you see yourself falling by the wayside. Lord, more of you and less of me. That is how it should go. That is how it should go. More of God in our lives and less of him. When you are a sheep that listens to his shepherd, You will never miss it in life, in all areas of your life. Maritally, academically, anyway, job-wise, in all areas of your life. Why? Because your shepherd, your God will guide you. He will order your steps. He will order your steps. He will order your steps. Oh, my shenanigans. I've been down that road before. Yes, that is confirmation. Yes. But don't. God is ever faithful. He loves us too much. He loves his sheep too much. He loves us. You don't know how precious you are. For him, for the hair on our heads to be numbered, for him to know you by your name, that means you are important. You are precious. You are unique. Fearfully and wonderfully made. Don't listen to the lies of the devil. He's a bastard. Come on, say the devil is a bastard. Don't be afraid, though. He can do you nothing if you have the Spirit of God. If you know you don't have Christ, don't say it too. But if you know you are a son and a daughter of God, Holy Ghost filled, and you know you're right in Christ Jesus, say it. The devil can do you nothing. He's a bastard. I can say it again and again. He knows he's a bastard. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Don't be deceived. Don't be carried away. Step. Seek his face. Seek his face. Seek his face. Mashente kurata palete kuyata. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So we are going to start from verse 7 now. Okay, 7. So Jesus said again, I assure you. He's a bastard. Oh, yes. A very big one. He's a very big fool. He's fooling about. The devil is a bastard. That's why. Not to see what the Bible said. He's roaming about. He's going to and fro, looking for whom to devour. Foolish devil. Deceiving people. Afflicting people. Ha. Let's continue reading from verse 7. We are reading John 10. We are now on verse 7 for those of you that are just joining. So Jesus said again, I assure you, I am the gate for the sheep. He is the way for the sheep. I am the gate for the sheep. All those who come before me, all those who came before me were thieves and robbers. All those that come before you that came before him, all those that pretended to come before him, all those that pretended to be walking for him, that are jumping through the fence instead of walking through the gates. Bible says they are thieves and they are robbers. You know them. Jesus is saying, I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. They will be able to come in and go out. They will find everything they need. Look at that. They will find everything they need. Whatever you need, every single thing that you need is wrapped up in Christ Jesus. There is none of your need that is not in Christ. There is none of your need that is not in Christ. My shame, the devil. John chapter 10, verses 1 to 21 is where we are treating now. So you can write it. It's John chapter 10, verses 1 to 21. But we've gone past verse 7. Now, we are on verse 9. He says, I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. Look at that. Jesus is the way. He says he's the gate. When you enter through him, you will be saved. Whoever enters through me will be saved. They will be able to come in and go out. You have freedom in Christ Jesus. You can go and come because you are free. You are not held under one bondage or the other. You will not be in bondage anymore. The devil cannot tell you, sit down there, where are you going? Get out. No, you will no longer be a tool in the hands of the devil. They will find everything they need in Christ Jesus, everything we need. A thief comes to steal, kill and destroy. But I came to give life. Life that is full and good. Look at Jesus. Look at the missions of the thief. Look at the mission of the devil. A thief, what does a thief? Let's even come in the physical. What does thief represent? They come to steal, to kill and to destroy. When armed robbers goes into any house, in Africa or wherever, in any part of the world, they break in. They came with a motive. They came on a mission to steal. They come on a mission to kill and to destroy. This is what the devil is after. He's here to steal from us the goodness, the glory of God, our testimonies, our blessings, our health, our life. Look at those demons that we are speaking through these people that God delivered last 2 weeks. They came into their lives and steal all that the Lord has given to them. What have you stolen? Their glory, their beauty, their this. Thief! That is all the mission the devil is after. That is all his missions, to steal, kill, and to destroy. How come? Can't you see people that the devil has entered into them, destroying their lives? Junkies on the street, drug addicts on the street, drunkards on the street, they become homeless. In a town like this, where they have help, in a town, in a country, I live in the UK, in a country that has government has funds for almost everything. These are citizens. They have taken over their lives. They do not even have control over their own lives anymore. They sleep on the streets. They are homeless. Why? Because the enemies has come in and they have stolen their peace. They have stolen their lives. This is all the devil is after. What about you? The devil have stolen, taking something that belongs to you today. By fire, by thunder, whatever the enemies have stolen, he is returning it back. Some of you, your husband, I see messages, inboxes and messages of a whole lot of sisters. Their husbands just wakes up in the morning, pack his bags and baggages and left the marriage. No fighting, no quarrel, no nothing. Just like that. Ha. They are retracing themselves back home. Because wherever they have moved to, they will not have peace. The Lord Almighty is bringing them back to their homes. In the name of Jesus. Look at how much the devil have stolen from people. Look at that demon speaking through that sister. We took her job. We took her car. We tried to kill her. We this, we that. Look at the bastard devil speaking. Taking, stealing, robbing from the people of God. Taking what belongs to us. Some of you, he's taking your job. They just tell you, oh, you can't work anymore. But God is going to give you another job, a better one. That job that will give you peace in the name of Jesus. Suddenly you want to get married. Another person just came and stole your fiance or fiancée. A few weeks to the wedding date. Or they so just say, no, I don't want to marry again. Something just drastically just happens. And that is the end of your glory, end of your testimony. I don't know what they have taken from you. But Jesus says, but I came to give life. That is God talking. Life that is full and good. Jesus said he has come to give us life. Life that is good. Life that is full. Which is life that is complete. Jesus, in some version, can just say life in abundance. So give, I have come to give you life, life abundantly. Life in abundance. Life that is full. That is why you need to stand up. That is why you need to stand your ground. That is why you need to tell the devil you are a liar. Hey, Jesus have come. He laid down himself for me. He has given me life in abundance, in great measures. You cannot steal what belongs to me. All you need is faith. All you need is to believe. Jesus said he has come to give you that life. All you need is to be saved. All you need is to invite Christ into your life. You are in Europe. You have your documents. Suddenly they seize your documents or they freeze your documents. Hey, you begin to cry and panic. For what? For what now? Say what happened. You begin to panic. Say what happened. That they took your documents. So you begin to cry. You begin to panic. Do you not know whom you are? Do you not know the authority that you carry? Release fire to them in that office. They will be uncomfortable. They will not have peace. They will not rest until they have given what is yours back to you. You've been given deportation. Deportation. When the Bible says that wherever the sole of your feet shall tread, the Lord has given it to you as your own inheritance, you are panicking. You are looking for contract pastors to contract so that they will go on the mountain and pray. When you can stand right there in your room and say, devil, you are a bastard. Devil, you are a liar. Ha. I am a daughter of heaven. I am a daughter of the Most High God. What? What my father says is what will happen. They will turn it around for your good. You will receive another letter telling you, oh, we are sorry we made a mistake. Why? Because you have taken care of it in the spiritual. Do you know that it is the spiritual that controls the physical? The spiritual. Learn to fight your battles in the spiritual. Don't go fighting in the physical. Fight in the spiritual because the spiritual controls the physical. When you fight in the spiritual, it begins to manifest in the physical. It begins to manifest in the physical. Mashende kulata parete kuyata. What is that? Princess of heaven. I told you guys the other time previously that you are a princess. You are a prince of heaven. You are a prince of heaven. You are a princess of heaven. Come on. You have right on this planet. We have right on this planet. Though we are in this world, we are not of this world. We are heavenly citizens. We are heavenly candidates. Mashente kurata kalata. Come on. Come on. Don't let the devil cheat you out of your destiny. Because you are so afraid. Because you don't know the authority you carry. Because you don't know the power that is in you. In Christ Jesus. The Bible says our Father, He is the King of all kings. What does that make you? If you're calling my Father, He's the King of kings. Then what does that make you? A princess of heaven. You are a royal priesthood, the Bible says. A chosen generation. A royal priesthood. Mashete kurata. I am a princess of heaven. I don't care what the devil says or thinks. I don't care what anybody says or thinks. My Father owns the earth. My Father created the universe. He is my Father. I am saved. I am born again. He speaks to me. I speak to him. He's the one that is in control of my life. He is the one that is guiding me. He is the one that is ordering my steps. I am not afraid. I am a princess of heaven. Are you a princess? Are you a prince? If you are a man, you are a prince. If you are a woman, you are a princess. The reason we don't understand is, come on, that is the more reason you should walk like a boss. Hey, you should be the one pushing the devil around. Push him. Push his head there. Push his head there. Get out. Get out of my way. Not him pushing you around. You are a prince. You are a princess of heaven. So you need to walk like a boss. Walk with confidence, knowing whom you are in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. Glory to God. Are you following me? Are you following? I am a princess of heaven. We are prince and princesses of heaven. Don't let the devil tell you otherwise. Look at what 11 says. I am the good shepherd. I am the good shepherd. Rababa shende. And the good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. Jesus. Do you see how powerful that place is? The good shepherd gives his life for his sheep. Jesus died for you. Jesus died for me. He gave his life for us, the sheep. The worker who is paid to keep the sheep is different from the shepherd. The paid worker does not own the sheep. So when he sees a wolf coming, he runs away and leaves the sheep alone. Then the wolf attacks the sheep and scatters them. The man runs away because he's only a paid worker. He does not really care for the sheep. You think all those pastors you are running to, they care for you? All they want is their daily bread. All they want is their something to just keep their body and soul together for that moment. That is all they want. That is all they are after. Let there be trouble. That is when you know. That is when you know how far. That is when you know. Hey, Jesus says the worker that is paid, he's getting his pay. So when the wolves come, he will abandon you there and run away. He will leave you there and run away. But the shepherd will never run. He will defend his sheep. He will defend you till the last. Even with a drop of his blood. It's just like you. You are welcome, Kate. You came late. It's just like you as an earthly father or mother. You will defend your babies. You will defend your children to the last, except if, I don't know, a parent that will not defend their children. I don't joke with my children, no. I don't joke with them at all. If you are a parent, you will not joke when you know when you know what you went through to have that child. Except I can't understand how some parents will be able to like abandon their children and just dump them there and go. But if you are a good parent, you will defend your children. That is God too. He defends us, his children, to the last. To the last. He will never run away. Your friends will abandon you. People around you will abandon you. Your church will abandon you. Anybody, people you trust, your family, they will abandon you. But Jesus, he says, he is the good shepherd. He laid his life. He will fight for us till the end. He will never abandon us. Oh, he will never abandon us at all. Even when everyone else turns around, turns against us, he will never turn against us. I am the shepherd who cares for the sheep. I know my sheep just as the Father knows me. And my sheep knows me just as I know the Father. I give my life for this sheep. Because see, I give my life for this sheep. I have other sheep too. They are not in this flock here. I must lead them also. They will listen. They will also listen to my voice in the future. My voice. In the future, there will be one flock and one shepherd. The Father loves me because I give my life. I give my life so that I can get it back again. No one takes my life away from me. I give my own life freely. Freely. I have the right to give my life. And I have the right to get it back again. This is what the Father told me. Jesus is still talking about himself. He's still talking about the sacrifice he's making. He made for us on the cross. He says he wasn't forced to do it. You see, nobody forced Jesus to come and die. Nobody forced him that God himself did not force him. He volunteered. God only asked, who is willing to go to sacrifice for my children, for my sheep? And Jesus stood up and said, Lord, I will go. Father, I will go. God, I will go, send me. He said he laid his own life down. He wasn't forced to do so. He wasn't forced to do so. He did it willingly. Why? Because he loves us. Why? Because he's got the right to do so. He is qualified to do so. And he did it for you and I. He did it. He did it. He has a right to lay it down. And he has a right to take it back. Because the Father loves me because I give my life. God has made you free will agent as well. You have a choice to either choose to serve God or not. He will not force you. You have a choice to surrender your life to him or not. He will not force you. We are in the era of grace, thank God. He's still giving you chances. He's still giving you chances because he loves you. And he wants to see that you change, you repent. Even when you still refuse to repent, he's still watching. But pray that the devil will not claim your life. Because the people that are in the grave, the people that are dead now, they cannot serve God anymore. They cannot praise God anymore. But the dead in Christ will arise on that day. They are only resting. The Bible says they are just sleeping, waiting for the day, for the resurrection day. And they will. We shall be risen with him. Again, the Jews were divided over what Jesus was saying. Many of them said a demon has come into him, made him crazy while listening to him. But others said, these aren't the words of someone controlled by a demon. A demon cannot hear the eyes of a blind man. Jesus is speaking to them in parables. Jesus was speaking to them about what was actually going on as at that time or what it was about to happen. But they lacked understanding. They refused to understand. They were still looking at him as the son of the carpenter. They even said that a demon has possessed him. They even begin to call God names. They begin to say that he's not controlled by God. A demon has entered into him. This is the man that is their father. The man that created them. The man that called them. 22. It was winter and the time came. It was winter and the time came for the festival of dedication. Say the network is bad. I think it's your network. Can you all hear me? Is my network okay? Kate, it might be your own network. Move around. Can you hear me? Can everyone hear me? Can everyone hear me? Type yes if you can hear me. Can everyone hear me? She's saying the network is bad. But I don't think it's my network. Is it my network? Nobody's typing. It's okay. All right. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. So, Kate, I think it's your own network. It's your network. Try to move around. Okay. Glory to God. So, I believe it's your network. Let's continue. You can now type again. We are going to go to 42 now. Because it's just like the same thing. It's just a repetition of the same thing. Hallelujah. So can you all type John chapter 10 verses 1 to 40. 1 to 42. Type for me. Time for me. John chapter 10, verses 1 now to 42. You know, before we stopped at 21, but now we want to carry on. We still have a few more minutes to go. We still have some minutes to go. And it's just repetition of what has been going on, Lord. So I'm just going to read it and then we explain. So can somebody type John chapter 10, verses 1 to 42? 1 to 42. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you all. Yeah, that's right. John 10, 1 to 42. So I'm going to just read everything now. I'm just going to read it down. We are on verse 23. Jesus was in the temple area at Solomon's porch. The Jewish leaders gathered around him. They said, "How long will you make us wonder about you? If you are the Messiah, then tell us clearly." Jesus answered, "I told you already, but you did not believe." God bless you all for typing. "I told you already, but you did not believe. I do miracles in my Father's name. These miracles show who I am, but you do not believe because you are not my sheep." See, because you are not my sheep. Not everybody is the sheep of Jesus. "My sheep listens to my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give my sheep eternal life. They will never die. And no one can take them out of my hand. Glory to God. Glory to God." Did you hear that? Jesus is still addressing them. "You've been hearing my voice, but you are not following." He says, "Because you are not my sheep." And these are supposed to be ministers. These are supposed to be pastors. These are the Pharisees, the scribes and the Pharisees. They are the ones that teach in the temple. They are the ones that preaches in the synagogue. And God is saying to them, "You are not my sheep." Because his sheep will hear his voice. They will listen, they will obey, they will follow. Don't you hear when Bible says, God was saying that many will come in my name. He will still say to them, "Depart from me, I know you not." They will say, "Lord, we prophesied in your name. Lord, we cast out demon in your name. Lord, we did this and that in your name." But he will still say to them, "Depart from me, I know you not, you workers of iniquity." My God, I pray that that will not be my testimony. I pray that that will not be your own testimony. That after all these sacrifices we are making on it, on that day he will still say to us, "Depart from me, I know you not." I pray that God will know us. I pray that heaven will recognize us in the name of Jesus. But if you are a sheep of Jesus, if you are living in disobedience to his words, if you are living in disobedience to his ways, if you are living in disobedience to the word of God, to the things of God, then you are not his sheep. That is what he says. He said here. That they are not his sheep because they are not obeying him. They are not listening to his voice. They are not following him. They were rather antagonizing him. They were rather fighting against him. They were rather judging him. They were rather just walking against him and against his teaching. There are people like that. All they do is to judge. All they do is to antagonize. All they do is to find fault. Fault finders, even in the church of God. You are looking at the pastor. All you are there to do is to find fault just to prove your point. You are just to find fault. These are not the people that God is looking for. These are not the people that God is looking for. Susan just joined. Oh, you are welcome in Jesus' name. You can go back later and watch the video again. In the name of Jesus. These are not the people that the body of Christ needs. You are finding fault. Pastor did that. Pastor's wife did that. Brother this did that. Brother, sister A did that. This, what about the one you yourself you did? You will not see it. But we are quick to see the one somebody else does. This is they were quick to see, find fault. Even though Jesus was pure, he was righteous, he was genuine, he was original. But yet they were even still seeking to kill him. Yes, they were trying to catch stone. Yes, they were still trying. They were going against every of his teaching. Do you know people will go against you? For whatever reasons, they went against Jesus. Don't be surprised. Even for me coming here to teach or here on Facebook, people will go against me. For yourself being here to watch, people will go against you. For you being a child of God, people will go against you. For you being a good worker in the house of God, people will say, today is my first time. Oh, God bless you, Margaret. You are welcome in Jesus' name. Your first time. How many first timers do we have today? God bless you. You are welcome. You are welcome. Everybody, welcome the first timers. Hallelujah. You are in the right place. God will speak to you. In the name of Jesus, our Father is here. The Holy Ghost is here. Glory to God. You can go back, watch all our previous videos. Then you can get to know us better. It is well with you in the name of Jesus. And all of you first timers, it is well with you all today in the name of Jesus. Heaven will answer your prayers in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. So people will hate you for whatever reasons. People will hate you for being you. People will hate you for being genuine. People will hate you for being sincere. People will hate you for telling them the truth. Why? Because they do not want to hear the truth. They do not want to hear the truth. And so, when you open your mouth to tell them the truth, they will hate you. They will hate you. Look at Jesus. For speaking the truth, they hated him. Ha. They refuse to understand. They refuse to understand. Jesus answered in 34, it is written in your law that God said, I said you are gods. These scriptures called those people gods. The people who received God's messages. And scriptures is always true. So why do you accuse me of insulting God for saying, I am God's son? Because he was speaking the truth. I am the one God chose and sent into the world. If I don't do what my father does, then don't believe what I say. He was here with proof. These same people, they ate. Oh, when you are new too. Oh, God bless you all. Grant, you are welcome in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Look at them. They were eating. When they were eating from that, Jesus felt them. They did not complain that time. Hey, Jesus. Oh, my God. When it's time to eat, they were there. So they tried to get Jesus again, but he escaped. See, they were even plotting to kill him. They were even, see, do you know that while you were there sleeping on your own, minding your own business, doing your own thing, there are still people, there are forces of darkness that are plotting against you. There are people that are planning against you. Do you know how many times they have mentioned your name in the shrine? Do you know how many times they have taken your name to somewhere else? You even send them your own money in Africa to bless them. They will take that money, go and put it in the shrine so that you will not make it. So that you will not do anything good. They will even take... Hello, Prabha? I'm online on my page. Yes, but right now I'm on live video. We'll come for prayer later at 9 o'clock, but now... 10 o'clock. But now I'm doing my live video on Facebook. Yes. All right, God bless you. Sorry about that. One of my followers. Glory to God. Do you know that while you are busy snoring on your bed, while you are busy minding your own business, some people are busy drinking paracetamol for your own headache. They are busy drinking fencic, paracetamol, and whatever pain relief on your own headache. Problem that is not their own. They are busy drinking paracetamol. Do you know some people are very good at that? They'll be drinking paracetamol for somebody. Say, ah, look at her. She's on Facebook again. Ah, look at her. She went to church yesterday. And look at her. Ah, is it only her? Oh, look at her. Hey, she just bought a new car. Ah, look at her. This one. Hey, God. I don't get it. Who is laughing now? Are you laughing because I said they are drinking paracetamol for your own headache? Well, it's your own case. It is your life. God will bless you however he chooses to bless you. God will lift you however he chooses to lift you. But they are there lamenting, crying. Hey. It still will not change what God will do. It still will not. Do you know there are some people that are supposed to be friends? They have never liked my video. They have never liked my video. Close friends, prayer partners. Back in the days. They will never share in your victory. They will never share in your testimony. They will never share in your joy. Hey, they are joy killers. They will even come. In fact, they know all the clothes you have in your wardrobe. The day you wear the one they don't know, they will come and ask you, have you released the new one again? When did you buy it now? They even begin to compete with you. Which shop did you buy it? Before you know it, they don't have money. They will go and take a loan and go and buy it because they are rubbish shoulders. They want to be where you are, even though they have not arrived. They are you use your own money you use in buying that car. It is your own money you use in building that house. It is your own money you use in buying your new shoes. It is your own money you use in buying your own clothes. They don't have it. They don't have it. They will go and borrow. Then after borrowing, is it by force? What are we dragging? Jesus was saying the truth to them. Jesus was busy telling them the truth. They were busy seeking for how to kill him. They were busy trying to lay hands on him. They were trying. God bless you, sir. They were trying. Trying. They will try to pull you down. They will try to judge you. They will try to find fault with you. In church, they will even set trap for you so that you will fall. They will set trap for you. And then when you fall, they say, hey, look at her, look at him. I thought he said he's a child of God. I thought she said she's a child of God. They are the one that will set that trap for you so that you will fall into it. And it is still the same them that will come and mock at you. It is the same them that will go and broadcast the fault, you're falling. The same one that will say, look at her, oh, look at him. They are the same one that will stab you in the back. And they are the one that will pretend to be following you, clapping after you. They will pretend to be your friends, friend enemies. Friend enemies. Jesus loves these people. He came for them. He was still talking to them about the sheep. He was still talking to them about his mission. Instead of them to follow, instead of them to listen to what? Everything in them was fighting against Christ. Everything in them was fighting against what Jesus was saying. Everything in them was fighting against the plans of God. In case you're not hearing me, it's your phone. Check it. Other people are hearing me because I can see their responses. It's your phone. Check it. You can come out of the video and come back again. Can someone type that for Kate? Kate, come out of the video and come back again. She says she's not hearing me. I think she's monitoring spirit. Yes, that is whom they are. Monitoring spirit, demonic agents. They'll be monitoring your life. They'll be monitoring your life. The day you buy a new dress, they know it. They will come and say, hey, you bought this. This one is new. I've not seen you. I've not seen this one on you. Must you know all my clothes? Must you know all my shoes? Must you know all my hairpiece? Must you know what else? Shoes, clothes, what else? Proper, my handbags. Must you? That you're not, hey, this one is new. Did you buy it? When did you, what is your own business? What is your own business? They are the first to discredit you. Jesus was so patient with them. Jesus was so patient. He was still explaining to them. He was still trying to get them to believe whom he is. But thank God for Jesus. Even though, you see the ones that will not, they are the ones that that claim to know it all. They are still the ones that were stressing Jesus. You know, those ones that they think that they know you. Sunglasses. That was it. They know all your sunglasses. Who said that? I want to see your name. It's true. They know your sunglasses. So, the day you wear a new sunglass, you have to explain to them where you bought it. Your lipstick. You guys are so funny. You are cracking me up now. Oh my God. They know all your lipsticks. So when you use a different color, they will come and ask you, ah, this is a new one. Where did you buy it? Oh my God. May God deliver us from those people in the name of Jesus. They were following Jesus up and down. Everywhere you see Jesus, you will see them. Everywhere you see Jesus, you will see them. But they were not there to listen to what he was saying. They were not there to surrender their lives to God. They were there to find fault. They were there to find fault. That's how they will be following you, monitoring spirits. You go here, they go. You come here, they come. You come here, they will come to your house. They will stay money till night, eat all your food. Stay in your house, money till night, eat all your food. They will go back and still talk bad of you. They will go back and still call you a bad person. They will go back and still see one evil and negative things to say. Even when they are there, people say, oh, that brother is a good girl. She helped me. Oh, that sister is this one. They'll say, who, that one? Forget story. Now we know him. That one. I know her inside out. I know him inside out. What are you talking about? They are beat this one. So they will count your shift for you. Fault finders. They were busy finding fault. But do you know something? While they were busy finding fault, Jesus was busy fulfilling his ministry. Don't be carried away with them. Don't be distracted with them. Don't be. Just continue with your ministry. Just continue to do what God would have you do. Just continue to be whom God has called you to be. Just continue. Do you know, a woman of God was preaching. She said when she started her TV ministry, many pastors rose up against her. Do you know that even me, There are people messaging me. Don't share your message on our platform again. What? On our group. Don't share your message on our group. I'm like, I thought we are working for the same body of Christ. I speak the truth about my father. Why should it be a problem? Why should it be a problem? And I replied to one, I said, I'm sorry. I cannot guarantee you that I will not share it in your group. So just delete me by yourself. Yes, they lie on you. They are the ones that will, because they think they know you too much. They say they know you too much. They know inside the, you know, they know, they knew Jesus too much. He's the son of the carpenter. They are his followers. They are following him up and down. They are following him up and down. Following him up and down. And they are following him is not because they love him. They were not following Jesus because they want to be blessed. They were not following Jesus because they want to hear the word and repent. They were following him to find fault. How many of them are following you? Monitoring spirits in the places of friends. Monitoring your life. They are following. They pretend to be friends. I pray for you today that the Lord will break the bond between you and those friend enemies in the name of Jesus. They do not have a place in your life. Let God separate you from them. Oh, there is a message I preach, separate from your lot. You guys go and look. Those of you that are joining, go on my page and check my messages. Go, actually, there is an easy way. When you go to a picture, photo, you see album, click the album. You see video, click the video. There is a video. There is one message I preach that says, separate from your lot. Separate yourself. It is not by fraud. They are afraid of, falling to make. Separate yourself from your lot. Lot did not have any contribution. He did not contribute anything. And you know these people, they always take from you. They keep taking from you. They keep taking from you. They will never give anything back. They will never give anything back to you. Not even their own time. You will sacrifice your time for them. You will sacrifice your comfort for them. You will sacrifice everything you have for them. But they will never give you anything in return. They will never give you anything back in return. Now, all they want is to take. Oh, please, that your shirt that you wore to church last Sunday, can I come and borrow it? That your shirt, can I come and borrow it? They will borrow it. You will be fighting them to return it. They won't even want to return it. So that you tell them, don't worry, keep it, take it. I dash you. You can have it. I don't need it. They will never contribute anything to your own life, but they keep taking from you. Lot in our life. Until Abraham separated himself from Lot, he did not come into his blessings. Do you know that? Lot was following every day. Lot was following wherever. Lot is even a relative. Lot is the son of Abraham's brother. Lot was following Abraham everywhere. Whenever Abraham he was on a pilgrimage, when he goes to this city, Lot was there. When he goes there, Lot was there. When he goes there, Lot, that is how they follow you up and down. They follow you up and down. It got to a point that they were both so blessed. As God, see, Lot never knew that Abraham was his covering. Lot never knew that Abraham was his covering. The way God was blessing Abraham, and he was also blessing Lot. And now their blessings were so much. They began to fight each other. The men, Lot's men began to fight Abraham's men. Abraham's men began to fight Lot's men. I think it got so bad for Abraham to call Lot and say, please, we are siblings. We are families. Look everywhere. It is plenty. The land is big enough. Choose. Even Abraham is older than Lot, but he allowed Lot to choose before him. That is how tired Abraham was. He was tired of the problem that Lot has been bringing into his life. Are you tired of the problem your so-called friends are bringing into your life? Hey, you built a house. Tell them you bought a land. Trouble starts. Hatred starts. Enmity starts. Are you the only one? Why should you be the only one? For no reason, self, some will stop picking your calls. Let them go. It's not by force. For no reason, self, they stop. They don't even want to see eye to eye with you. Even you will call them, are we quarreling? No, we are not quarreling. No. Something hidden in the heart. The heart of man is deceitful and desperately wicked. Who can know it? Who can know it? Who can know it? I can only vouch for myself. I know myself. I know my heart. You can only vouch for yourself. You know yourself. You know your heart. But the heart of man, the heart of man, hey, Lord, look at this. When Abraham even called Lot, because I told you now, they always collecting. They don't give back. Abraham told Lot, look, choose. Lot lifted up his eyes. He saw all the areas that was green. He saw the areas that was fruitful in his head. Oh, he thinks he's smart. He saw the areas that is green. He did not even consider Abraham. He didn't consider Abraham. He did not say to Abraham, Abraham, you've tried for me. You have been helping me. He did not even appreciate Abraham. You've been taking me from one city on this journey. You have been like an anchor. You have been my help. You have been my backbone. Abraham, I don't want to leave you, but no. As my senior, please, you choose. I will choose any other land. His greed. He looked. He saw the green part. Quickly, he chose that part. He chose that side. He did not even think twice about Abraham. That is how those your friends are. They don't care what happens to you. They don't care whether you make it in life. They don't care whether you succeed. All they care about is that you should be giving to them. You should be blessing them. You should be there for them. They will wear you out. They are never grateful. Even when you get to say, hey, what is it? Is it because you gave me this one? You just gave me this iPhone. Is that why you will not let me rest? If not, come and take your phone, Jare. What is it? This is their attitude. They say, come and take it, Jare. Come and take it. Is it because you give me this shoe that you will not let me have peace? Are you the first person? Very ungrateful set of human beings. No, even if you cut off your neck and give it to them, they will not appreciate you. Even if you cut off your leg, your hands, and give it to them, they will still ask you, what did you do for me? They will still ask you, what have you done? They will still ask you, what did you do? Lot did not think twice. Lot did not even consider Abraham when he was choosing his place. He did not even say, let's reason together. This side is green, that side is not green. How do we come to a compromise so that you will be blessed? At least me too, I'll be blessed. Quickly, greed. He ran. That is how he got into slavery. He took himself into slavery. Do you know that Lot took himself into slavery? He never knew that land he was being ruled by Sodom and Gomorrah. He never knew that he was putting himself in danger. And before long, he was captured. The Lord is going to capture your enemies today. In the name of Jesus. He is going to capture your enemies today. He's going to separate. He's going to put a separation between you. We don't need them in our lives. The day you don't give them, you become an enemy. They become your enemy that day. That day, malice will start. Or emergency malice will start. Do you know, out of greed, Lot sold himself into slavery. Because he was open eye, itier eye. He was looking for green pastures. He did not even consider Abraham. But Abraham is a man of God. Abraham still went to fight and got love. Go and read it. Abraham heard that Lot was captured. He still went and rescued him. Do you know that even though when they are in problem, you are the first person they will still call you? Because they know you have a good heart. They know that you cannot say no. They know that you have Christ in you. It's not that they don't know. They do. When they call you, answer them. Help them and still leave them with their life and move on with your life. Yes, I'm a living witness. So you see, many of us, it has happened to me too. It has happened to a whole lot of us. If you have experienced anything like this, just testify to it. Lot was in problem. In that great land, he thought he was captured now. It was still Abraham that went to go and rescue him. Because Abraham is a child of God. Abraham is a son of God. He loved Lot. But Lot never cared about Abraham. And that is how he found himself in slavery. He found himself in slavery, Sodom and Gomorrah, because of long throat, because of big eye, because of green pastures. I pray that God will separate us from our lots in the name of Jesus. That's why I have a lot. Hallelujah. You see? Thank you, Jesus. So they were setting trap for Jesus. But Jesus escaped them and their trap. It doesn't matter how many traps they are setting for you. It doesn't matter how many times they have laid in wait for you. It doesn't matter how many times they are seeking your downfall. The God of the heavens will continue to disgrace them, will continue to embarrass them, will continue to frustrate all their evil efforts against your life, against your family, in the mighty name of Jesus. Rabba shende kuradaba sente kayata. 40 said, then he went back across the Jordan River to the place where John began his work of baptizing people. Jesus stayed there. And many people came to him. They said, John never did any miraculous sign. But everything John said about this man is true. And many people there believed in Jesus. He had to leave that environment. Jesus had to leave them with their wickedness. Jesus had to leave them. He left them to their fate. He went to the place where he began his ministry, where John was baptizing people. That is where he himself got baptized. Jesus went back there. And it's recorded that many people came to him. Many people, when he went to that place that he's recognized, he's appreciated, that he's known, he's loved, many came to him and said, John did not perform all these miracles you are performing, but everything that John said about you is true. And it's happening. And the Bible recorded that many people there believed in Jesus. Many people there gave their lives to Jesus. Many people there surrendered their lives. Sometimes that is what you need. You need to change your environment. Sometimes you need to change your friends. Sometimes you need to let go of some friends. Friend enemies. Let them go. Let them go. Let them go. There are some friends you don't need in your life. Cut them off when they are stressing you. It doesn't mean that when they need help, you shouldn't help. Help them and still leave them to carry on. Leave them to carry on. Because even though you cut your head, cut your leg and your arm, give it to them, they still will not appreciate. But you do what God wants you to do in their lives. If God brings you in a situation where you are to do something, do it for them and move on with your life. My sheep, they hear my voice and they follow. Are you a sheep of God? Who is controlling your life? We have come to the end of our teaching. This is family as well. Oh, yes. There are some families that are the worst. Do you know there are some families? Oh, my goodness. Ha. Even if you build house, put them inside, they will still ask you, what have you done? Call them off. It doesn't mean that you shouldn't help them. Help them. But help them in the Lord. Prayerfully help them. Do you know that families are the ones, like we in Africa, you will send money to your family, some family members. They will take it to the herbalist. They will take it to some spiritual house. They will take it to some demonic places just to hurt you. Because they don't want to see you move on. They are jealous. You are abroad. Why should you be abroad and they are in Africa? Why are you not coming to take them? Why are you not doing this? And they begin to throw arrows today. I pray for you. Anyone throwing arrows to you, whether from your family, whether from Africa, whether from anywhere, today, the fire of the Holy Ghost upon them in the name of Jesus. Yes, wisdom. That is why you need wisdom in dealing with families, extended or near. You need to know whom they are, what is in them. Are they saved? Some of them, they are the one, your first enemy says in some families, they are in some people, some families, they are the first enemy that you have. They don't see you face to face, but they are there plotting and planning evil against you. They are there taking your clothes to one shrine. They are there taking one thing or the other that belongs to you to one place. Ha. I know a sister, she's watching. A sister in this platform. She had to cut off from all their families because nothing good. Nothing good. No good plans. They don't want anything good for her. Nothing good. If you belong to such family, cut off. Cut off. If God gives you grace to assist any one of them, assist them and move on. Even before you release your finance to anybody, before you receive, say, let them eat their own condemnation. Before you release anything, anoint it. Pray hard. Pray on it. Pray on it. Anything you are giving them, anoint it. Pray on it before you release them. If you belong to such families. Some of us belong to those families where witchcraft is the order of the day in that family. And then you are there, you are giving them your clothes. You are giving them your money. They will take it to the coven. Don't you realize, some of you now, somebody here you are watching. You sent money home one time to somebody. The Holy Ghost is just saying this to me. You sent money home, and since you sent that money, things turned around against you. Things began to work against you. You are watching now. The Holy Ghost just brought that to me now. That you were living fine, and then you blessed somebody or did something for somebody, whether it's home or abroad. But since you gave that money out, since you gave that thing out, your life has never been the same again. You have constantly been under attack. You cannot keep a job anymore. You cannot keep a job anymore. You cannot keep a job anymore. If it's you, you are watching me. You are watching me. The Holy Ghost says you are watching. Since you did this thing, you saw yourself struggling. You began to struggle. Your life is a constant struggle. For you to eat, you have to struggle. Even your jobs are good. Things are no longer working well for you. Things are no longer working well for you. Rababo shende kurada bo sente he. Mashanda da bo sende kurata. Mata kulete kuyata. Rababa shende. We want to start praying now. We finish the message for today. Randa kulete kayata. We finish the message for today. Masende de bo shanda ha. Oh, begin to lift up your own voice. Lift up your own voice and begin to cry out to heaven. Holy Spirit, maskente he. Ratatata kulete kurata. Maskende de bo shanda ha. Letete kuyete basanda ha. Rataba lete kurada bo sende he. You are struggling in your life. Who is struggling here? Nothing works for you anymore. Nothing works for you anymore. Nothing works for you anymore. When you try this, it folds up. When you try that, it closes up. When you try this one, it closes up. Nothing works for you anymore. You are watching. Don't be ashamed. When God does or says things like this, it's because he wants to deliver you. It's because he wants us to pray. It's because he wants us to pray about it. Matarete kulata. Your life is a struggle now. You have to struggle to keep a job. You have to struggle to do this or that. Constant struggle. Ma shedebo sende kurada. Ma sente kulata kayata baba. Jesus, ma skende hoch. I want all of you begin to pray. The rest of you begin to pray. And say, Lord, give me the grace to always hear your voice. God revealed to redeem. That is right. Hallelujah. Your sheep hear your voice. Father, give me grace to always hear you. Grace to always hear your voice. Grace to always hear your voice. Grace to always listen to you. Grace to always hear your voice and to follow you. That you will be the shepherd of my life. That you will be the one in control of my life. Ma santa kurada bo sende retetete kule de bo shende basanda ya mata kurada bo skende ratatatata shende bo sende kulada mata tata bareke basende mata tarete bo sende kurada lende ko sende kayata ma shende de bo sende ma shende de bo sende ma shende de bo sende mata kurada baba Yeke libo sende balente kayata. Rapapas kende kurada bo sende he. Masente kurada bo shanda ha. Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus. Masente kuyada ba. Rete kurata pasente he. Lord, intervene. Begin to pray. Intervene, oh God. Intervene, intervene. Intervene, intervene. Intervene, intervene. Masanta kayata. Masanta kayata. Rete te 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 te. Maskende de bosh, maskende de bosh, maskende de bosh, rakaba baba shanda da da da, rete te 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 masente he. Begin to pray, begin to commit yourself to God, begin to pray. This message has touched you. Begin to pray, maskende bosh, begin to pray, ra da 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 da, lete kuyete basente he, randa da da bosh shanda ha. Begin to pray, begin to pray, maskende bosente kulata. Maskende boskente kulata. Matanta kurata baba shende. Oh Jesus. Ah, Father, release all our network in the name of Jesus. Release our networks in the name of Jesus. Mashente kurata. Says my video is not showing what is happening. Somebody has also said, hey, the devil is a bastard. I told you before, he's a bastard. Foolish devil. Maskende bot. Father, let those networks right now be restored in the name of Jesus. Mashente kurata baba baba. Masende de boshanda ha. Rete kulete kulete. Maskende boshanda da da boz. Rada baba babash. Mata yete kulete. Mashanda da da boz. Lord, we worship your name. Begin to pray for yourself. Begin to pray for yourself. Begin to pray for yourself. Lord, the Lord will not force you. He will not force you to be saved. He will not force you to be born again. He will not force you to serve him. But you say, Lord, give me the grace to serve you. Help me to be faithful to you. Help me to be sincere with you. Help me to be an open book before you. Lord, help me. Lord, help me. Maskende boshandaha. Maskende boshandaha. Maskende boshandaha. Lete lite lata. Maskente kurata. Yebraga bosentehe. Mata lete kayata. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Masken, say, I begin to receive grace. Oh, shanda da da ba. Masken de de bush. Oh, if your network is bad, come out and come back in. I don't know what is why the devil is attacking your networks. You just come out and come back in. Masken de bush shanda ha. Rabababa sente ye. Ilete ba lete ba lete ba. Matarete kuyete. Nete te 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 te. Begin to say, Lord, I receive grace to follow you. I receive grace to be a sheep, a good sheep, even as you are a good shepherd. Oh, the grace to listen to your instructions. You know, sometimes God is speaking to you and you feel, you convince yourself this is not God. You convince yourself this is not God speaking. You begin to bind and cast. Hey, Jesus is speaking. Oh, once have you spoken, twice have I heard, that will be your own testimony. In the name of Jesus, when God is directing you, move to this place, you will know this is God speaking. Say, Lord, help me to be sensitive in the spirit, that I will recognize when you speak, that I will recognize when you speak, that I will recognize when you speak. Understanding. Somebody says yes. Begin to pray, Lord, give me that understanding. In the name of Jesus Christ, give me the understanding to hear you, to understand you, to identify your voice. Some of us, even now, we still get confused. You cannot differentiate the voice of God from the voice of the Holy Spirit from the voice of the devil. You will mistake the voice of the devil for the voice of God. And when the end result comes, you're like, but God, you said. But God wasn't the one speaking. It was the enemy speaking because they want to mislead you. So go to the Lord in prayer and say, Lord, I surrender. Lord, I surrender. Lord, I surrender. Hey, open my spiritual ears. Open my spiritual ears. Open my spiritual ears. That I will hear you when you speak. 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 In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, we worship your name. We exalt you. We adore you. We give you praise. We give you glory. May your name be praised forever. 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 Lord, we worship your holy name. Yes, in the name of Jesus. You are going to pray this prayer now before we go. Father, separate me. As you separated Lot from Abraham, separate me from my enemies. Separate me from my friend enemies. Friends that are actually enemies and pretend to be friends. Lord, separate me from them. Put enmity between me and them. You may not know them. Hey, you may not know them, but God knows them. God knows them, Lord. You may even know them. If you know them, separate yourself. Find a way to detach yourself. If you don't know them, say, Lord, reveal them to me and separate me from them in the name of Jesus. Lord, separate me from those friend enemies. Friend enemies, separate me from them. Begin to pray. As you separated Lot from Abraham, separate me from all my enemies. Enemies of progress. Enemies that don't want to see anything good happen to me. Lord, separate me from them. Lord, separate me from my enemies, home and abroad. It doesn't matter where they are, whether they are in your city, whether they are in your church, in your community, whether they are in your village, they are in your town, from your country, wherever they are coming from, we don't care to know. But Lord, separate me from them. Lord, separate me from them. Jesus, separate me from them. Lord, separate me from them in the name of Jesus. Mashende go bo sente. Rada da da bo sanda kuyete. Maskende de bo shanda ha. Separate me from all my enemies. Oh, Jesus, Jesus. Hey, in the name of Jesus. Forget to say, Father, deliver me from every gang up. Every gang up of the wicked. Every gang up of the wicked. Every gang up of the wicked against my life. Father, I pray your mighty hand of deliverance. Daddy God, I pray for your mighty hand of deliverance. In the name of Jesus, upon me, upon my marriage, upon my children, upon my life, upon me generally. Begin to pray, Lord, deliver me. Father God, deliver me, deliver me. Deliver me, O God, my Father. Deliver me from the hands of the wicked. Deliver me from the plots of the wicked. Deliver me from the hands of my enemies. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father God, deliver me, O God. In the name of Jesus, deliver me. In the name of Jesus, deliver me. In the name of Jesus, deliver me. Oh God, my Father, Lord, I worship you. Everlasting King, I exalt you. I am delivered, O God, from every stronghold. My shandarabos. In the name of Jesus, you need to pray this prayer. Say, Lord, wherever my name has been mentioned for evil, wherever my name has been mentioned for evil, wherever they have taken my names to, my money to, my clothes, my shoes to, wherever spiritual house that is holding anything like an image that is made on my behalf, that they are using as a point of contact to reach me on fire, on fire, on fire, on fire, fire of God, consume them, consume them, consume them, consume them, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, mashente kurata. Pray that prayer with all seriousness. You don't know where your images have traveled to. You know, you are here in Europe. And then, you know, like my mother, when she was alive, I used to send my mother my pictures, the pictures of my children. You know, my mother is a good woman. I love her to pieces. Oh, my mother. Ah, she does not joke with any of her children. Wow, that woman. Hey. She will fight you because of her children. I love my mom. But not all families like that. Some of them, you send them your pictures and they begin to take that picture to the shrine. They begin to go and put it on that one juju. They be, especially we from Africa. They begin to take your picture, the picture of your husband or your children. They will begin to go and put it somewhere. They take it somewhere and they begin to use it to attack you. They begin to use it to attack you. They begin to use it to attack you. Some of you, you don't even know it. They have made images in your name and they are using remote control for you. That is why sometimes, do you not realize, if they mistakenly call you that they need £1,000 or €1,000, $1,000, $1,000, whatever, 500, even if you don't have it, you will go and borrow. You will go and borrow because they are using this remote control to control you. Once you hear that they need money, until you give them that money, you will not have peace. Remote control. You are going to pray for yourself. Hey, Lord, whatever they are using to control my life and destiny, whatever charm they are using to control me, Father, I set it on fire. Release the fire of God upon it. Lord, I set it on fire. Lord, let it catch fire. Oh God, let it catch fire. My God, let it catch fire. Nandabo shanda da da da. Iretebo lete kayata. Lord, let it catch fire. Let it catch fire. Let it catch fire. Do you know, even if you don't send this money to them, they are living better than you. They are living very, very well. But they use this remote to control you. They use it. Ha. Except you did not hear it. Except you did not hear it. Let them just open this their mouth and say, ah, we need money. Oh. They will even give you the price they want. They can tell you 2,000 euros, dollars or pounds, whatever. Or tell you 1,005, or they tell you 500 or 300. Do you know, you, until you send them that money, you yourself, you will not have peace. You'll be like somebody that is confused. You'll just be going like, you know, even when you don't have, you want to borrow and send. Ha, that is not the will of God. That is not the will of God. Something has happened in the spiritual. Remote control. Begin to pray, Lord, everything, if there be anything that they have used as a remote control to control my life and destiny, Father, let it catch fire. Let it catch fire. Let it catch fire. Let it catch fire. wherever it is in the shrine, wherever it is in any demonic kingdom, wherever it is in the junctions, wherever it is, wherever they have put it, let it catch fire. Lord, let it catch fire. Daddy, let it catch fire. In the name of Jesus, catch fire. Lord, let it catch fire. In the name of Jesus Christ, begin to decree and prophesy to yourself. No weapon fashioned against me shall prosper. Some of you, they have so tied it that you will not be married. You will not get married. A sister was saying to me, one of her aunties said, as long as she is alive, she will not get married. Eh? Hey, I don't know who has said that to you. They beat their chest and say, as long as I am alive, you will never marry. You will never have peace in your marriage. Ah, they have already passed judgment on themselves. They have already passed judgment on themselves because you have to marry. Because your life has to move forward. They say, as long as they are alive, except they repent and denounce. If they refuse to change or repent, and they are still there putting fire in your case, putting fire so that no man will see you and say they love you, so that no woman will see you and say I love you, according to their own decree, according to the words of their mouth, now so shall it be. Mas sente kuradaba, mas kende de boshanda, ratatata lete kuyete, mas kente kurataba, mas shanta kurada, lete tete te landa kaya, ranadada boshende. Begin to decree, begin to declare it. Lord, I must get married. Lord, I must have my own children. Lord, I must get a good job. Lord, I must get my documents. Lord, I must move on. Lord, your light must shine in my way. Lord, helpers of my destinies must locate me in the name of Jesus. Anyone beating their chest for my sake, anyone saying or doing incantations or doing one evil thing or the other that I will not succeed in life, that I will not succeed in life, that my children will not succeed in life. Father, according to their own word, they said over their dead body, they will die. Hey, they will die. Lord, they will die except they repent. Except they repent. Except they repent. If they repent, have mercy. But if they refuse to repent and they insist on that to happen, Lord, visit them with your wrath. Let it be unto them according to their own pronunciation. Let it be unto them according to their own pronouncement. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hey, I must succeed. Begin to tell yourself what you want. What do you want for yourself? What do you want to see in your life? I must succeed. Lord, I am born. Begin to decree into your life. Begin to decree that single thing. Begin to decree it into your life. Hey, Lord, I must succeed. I am born to reign. I am born to be a success. I will make it in Jesus' name. I am unstoppable. Hey, the kingdom of darkness cannot stop me. I am unstoppable. No demons can stop me. No man, no woman, no boy, no girl, no child, old or young can stop me. In the name of Jesus, I am made for signs and wonder. I that the Lord has given me, my household, my family, my children, my ministry, my job, everything that relates to the call of God upon my life. We are made for signs and wonders. Hallelujah. 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 Begin to decree to your own self. What do you want to see happen in your life? You are getting married. Say, this year, my husband will locate me. This year, my wife will locate me. This year, I will conceive and bear my own children. This year, goodness and mercies are my portion. In the name of Jesus. This year, that job will locate me. That job that you have given to me, it will locate me. In the name of Jesus. Manda da da bo shende de 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 de. Rata kula da ba shende kuyata. Raka pos kende de de boj. Mate kula da bo sende he. Randa da da bo shende he. Maka yete kula ta ba sende ya. My God, my God, my God. Oh, you can see everything is turning around for our good. In the name of Jesus. Rada ba 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 ba. Rende de de bo shende he. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we worship you. Ma shende de de boj. 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 Rete 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 rete. Ma skende de de boj shanda ha. Ma skende de de boj shanda ha. Ma skende de de boj skende he. Rete de boj sende he. I can see Lord Chiyoba. Ma skende bo 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 shende ya baba. Lende de de bo 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 shanda ra ba shanda ha. Rete kula da ba 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 ba. Ma skende de de boj shende he. Ma skende de de boj shanda ha. Ra da 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 boj skende de de de. Lord, I give you praise. I give you praise. Begin to say, everything is turning around for my good. Everything is turning around for my good. Everything is turning around for my good. Begin to declare it. I can see everything turning around for my good. Everything is turning around for my good. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Mashandara. Everything is turning around. Mashandara, we're worshiping with this song. I can see everything turning around. It's turning around for your good, for my good. Everything is turning around for our good. I can see everything turning around. Just worshiping with this song before we go. Yes, yes, the devil cannot stop it. Oh, the devil cannot stop it. I can see everything turning around for my good. Mashanda ba 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 ba. Rete kulata ba. Do you believe it? Do you believe it? Everything is turning around for my good. For the good of my children. For the good of my family. In the name of Jesus. Just worshiping with this song. Believe it. Trust in this song. Everything. I can see everything turning around for my good. Everything is turning around. Begin to say it. I can see everything turning around for my good. Mashanda Baba. Hallelujah. Everything is turning around. Everything is turning around for me. Oh, the Lord is changing my story. Oh, the Lord is changing my glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Mashanda Baba. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We worship you. Everything is turning around for our good. The lives of my children are turning around for our good. My job is turning around for my good. In the name of Jesus. Everything that God has given me. Every blessing. Thank you, Jesus. Everything is turning around. Everything is turning around. Do you believe it? Do you believe it? Can you see everything turning around? Everything is turning around. Everything is turning around. I can see everything turning around. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Mask in the name of Jesus. Everything is turning around for our good in the name of Jesus. Everything is turning around for my good. Yes, and my family, that's right. That's right, Sanders, that is right. Everything is turning around for my for the good of my family. Everything is turning around for my good. I can see it already turning around. I can see it already turning around. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord Jesus. Randa bo shende kulata. Mas kende kulata ba. Rakapos kende de bo. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It is settled. It is settled. It is settled. Glory to God. Everything is turning around for our good in the name of Jesus. If you're on this platform and you haven't given your life to Jesus, I want you to come to him now. See, you cannot fight your battles for yourself. Jesus died on the cross for you and I. He loves you so much. You matter to him. You are precious to him. You are important to him. I want you to come before him and say, Lord, I come before you. Father God, I know that I am a sinner in need of help. Touch me with your salvation, O God. Touch me one more time. I surrender my life to you. Have mercy upon me, Jesus. Wash me with your blood. Cleanse me from every sin. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. I accept you today, Lord, as my Lord and personal Savior. I know, God, that I am born again. Thank you for washing my sins away. Thank you for accepting me back into the family of Christ. Thank you, Jesus, because now I belong to you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you all. In the beginning, I announced in the beginning that our 3 days, some of us are late. That is why I'm repeating it now. Our 3 days of supernatural encounter and deliverance is coming up. In about 2 weeks from now, in less than 2 weeks from now, I think it should be on the 15th. Let me just check the exact date. So for those of you that are new, It's a 3 days program. We fast and pray for 3 days. It is a supernatural encounter and deliverance. It's a deliverance program. So it doesn't matter what is going on. You just come fasting and the mighty hand of God will touch you in the name of Jesus. Let me just confirm the exact date. Yes, it's going to start on the 15th. So it's going to be 15th, 16th, and 17th. We did it, it's every month. It's a monthly program on this platform. We did it for last month. It was last month. One was powerful. Too powerful. In fact, oh, God moved. It was indeed a supernatural time in his presence. And so it's going to be on the 15th, 16th, and 17th of this month. It's going to be 15th, 16th, and 17th of this month. The poster, watch out for the poster or flyer. It will be out. You know, can anybody make good flyers? Okay, I pay now. I pay to make those posters and flyers. It's not free. Oh. When you see them there, it's not free. I'm paying for it. So if you are gifted, you know how to make posters and flyers. You can be doing it for us for free. And God will bless you too. All I will do is just to send you pictures of the guest speakers. You do it, you send it to me, and then we post it. So if you are gifted in that department, let me know. Work for God. Use your giftings for God. I was trying to be trained yesterday. It was just the minor ones, but if you watch like those flyers on my page, you will see some of the flyers there. So if you are gifted to make flyers for program, let me know. If you want to be doing it for us, give God your time. Let me know. I will just send you the information and you will do it and send it to me on WhatsApp and I will post it. That is all. So we don't need to be paying for it. I am paying for it, even though I'm not asking you guys for money. The one we did for the last one, I paid for it. I paid for it. Hallelujah. It is my Father's work. I told you guys I am ready to do anything for him. Spend what I need to spend for souls to be saved, for you to be delivered. I paid for the posters we use for these programs. The seminar, the marriage seminar we did, and the 3 days of a supernatural encounter in the name of Jesus. Oh, God bless you for posting. Oh, yeah, that's right. That is right. So I'll be contacting the speakers, the ministers that God will use for the program, including myself. It's going to be an awesome time. Who is ready to fast for 3 days? Who can do 3 days dry, 3 days with liquid, 3 days fasting? Anyhow, you can do cyst to cyst for 3 days. You can do dry for 3 days. You can do with liquid for 3 days. I'm going to make it do a fasting that is convenient for you. Those of us that can do 3 days dry, we'll go on with our 3 days. Those of us that cannot, you can do the one that is convenient for you. But the most important thing is that be a part of that fasting and be a part of that program and watch God transform your life in the name of Jesus. And next month we are going to be having 7 days, hallelujah. We're going to be having 7 days of 7 days of glory is the theme of that program. So I'm going to also get the ministers ready. 7 days of fasting, but because it's 7 days, we'll be doing 6 to 6. We'll fast from 6 in the morning and break 6 in the evening. When we finish the evening program, we can break. We'll always come online 6 a.m. and we'll come online again in the evening. So when we finish the program in the evening, we break. So we'll come back again. That is one is for next month. So next month is 7 days. 7 days of glory. So we are going to be covering all areas. Marriage, children, partners, you name it. In that 7 days. And I know God will move. So just get ready. And the Lord is going to bless you. Also, we have 4 conferences coming up in Nigeria. We did it this year in February, March, and we are planning another one. It's 4 different conferences, different cities, different states in Nigeria. We are doing one in Benin City. We are doing one in Ekpe, Lagos. We are doing one. The date for the Days of Glory is, I have the date. It's the last week in June. Let me get you the exact date so you can mark your calendars and get ready. The 7 days will be starting on the June. Let me get the exact date. The posters will be out, don't worry, but just so you get yourself ready, it's going to start on the 22nd to 28th. No. It's going to start on Saturday. June. Come back. It's starting on Saturday. It's going to be from the 23rd. It's starting on Saturday, the 23rd of June to the 29th of June. It's the 7 days of glory. 7 days of glory is starting 23rd of June to 29th of June. 7 days of glory. Hallelujah. You can type it again, sis. God bless you. 7 days of glory. Go and mark your calendar. Those 7 days with fasting. We'll be doing 6 to 6. If you can fast for the 7 days, go ahead and fast. But the program is for 6 in the morning to 6 in the evening. We'll be fasting too. And usually when you hear 6 to 6, you stop eating when it's 12 midnight. After 12 midnight, you don't eat anymore if you are fasting. So, you know, like the Muslims, they can eat like 5 a.m. No, you don't eat 5 a.m. 7 days of glory starts, that's right, yes, of June. So, mark it in your calendar. The posters will be out by the grace of God. So, I just need to speak to the guest speakers, the ministers that will do the program with us. It's live here on Facebook. Live on Facebook. Don't worry. Don't worry that you are. It's live on Facebook. God is doing wonders. Some people got delivered. Go and watch our previous videos. You will see deliverance. Somebody in Jamaica got delivered. Somebody in Europe, they got delivered. Some people, not even somebody, people in Europe, they got delivered. So distance is no barrier. You come with your faith. That is all God wants you to do. Come with your faith, believing and trusting God, and He will move in your life. In the name of Jesus. About the conference, we are having our conference, 4 conferences in Nigeria. And the conferences, it comes with women empowerment, where we train the women. We train the women on something. The one we did last year, we trained them how to make tack powder, vim, and liquid soap. But I don't know what we are going to be training them with next year. It is the church that will tell us what it is. The women in the church, they will tell us what they want. And we finance it. We just finance it. We also bless the widows. And this time around, we are going to be doing prison ministries and all of that. And all of this cost money. And so that is the reason you are seeing the PayPal, my details on your screen. Please bless this ministry. Bless that conference. Be a blessing to these women. Be a blessing to these widows. Be a blessing to the prisoners. Be a blessing to the orphans. God is leading me now. He's just been talking to me to take the orphans out. I pray the orphanages will allow us to do that. So we are going to take the orphans. We're just going to get a coastal bus, take all of them out for a picnic or to the zoo. And we want to take care of them for the whole day, feed them for the whole day. When we take them out, I don't know, we might carry coolers of rice or something. We might just get caterers. Maybe we'll get caterers to cook for us. We'll just go have picnic somewhere or go to the zoo, take them to the zoo first, and maybe take them somewhere for picnic. And then they will sit down and eat and drink. Spend the whole day. In the evening, they just will take them back to their orphanage, and then they will go and sleep. That is what the Lord is learning. Make them bring smiles on people. Say, this is what God wants us to do. This is the will of God for us. So that is my PayPal address there. If you want to pay directly to Nigeria account, if you click on there is a Nigerian account number there too. You can click on the Nigerian account number, or you can use PayPal. If you want to send Western Union or MoneyGram, inbox me so I can give you details for that. If you want to send Western Union or MoneyGram, inbox me and I will give you details of the person that can collect it in the name of Jesus. Be a part of this blessing that is coming. Be a part. We are going to air it. It's going to be on live. We'll show everything we are doing on live. You will see what we do. The one we did the last time is there. It's in the among the videos, the conference. We showed it on live videos on Facebook. It was awesome, you know. People gave their lives to God. There is nothing more fulfilling than that. For you to see souls, you know, being won for the kingdom of God. That one is priceless. And I know this one we did this year was the first one. So the one we are doing now is going to be our second one. And it's going to be more powerful. It's going to be greater. Because the Holy Ghost is already in it. In the name of Jesus. So please support us to do all of this. I've just mentioned this conference. The budget is for £10,000. Because it's 4 conferences. 4 different locations, flight is there, transportation is there, orphanage home is there, prison there. We are buying 200 Bibles to give out. 200 Bibles, that is what the Lord is laying in my heart. And we are going to be giving this to the prisoners, to the prisons. We are also going to be giving some to the orphanages. We are going to be giving some to people that give their life to Christ during the program. We will give them Bible to take home because some of them may not even have Bible. So maybe they may not even have enough to afford it. But we are going to buy Bibles. We are going to give Bible to all the people that give their life to God. So we are going to have about 200 Bible. We are going to get about 200 Bible ready. If we finish, we'll go and get some more. I trust God. I am believing God for souls in this conference. I am believing God to touch lives in this conference. You guys will watch it you will watch it here live in the name of Jesus. And continue to pray. Above all, we need your prayers. be praying towards these conferences that the mighty hand of God will move, that God will provide all the finance that we need. It's huge, it's big, I know, but I'm not afraid because I know God will provide. And so if God is leading you to support this conference, please be a part of it and surprise and support us in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. And be praying towards it as well. I pray that the Lord will bless you. May he cause his face to shine upon you. I pray that you will never lack anything good in your life. In the name of Jesus, I decree and I prophesy into your life that it is well with you. It is well with your family. It is well with your finance. It is well with your job. It is well with your children. It is well with your marriage. It is well with anything that concerns and connects to you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for the lives of your people. Thank you for the grace to stay here in your presence. Thank you for all you've done for us today. Thank you for this broadcast. We cover this broadcast in the blood of Jesus. I cover every one of you watching and those that have watched and maybe they've gone to work. I cover them in the blood of Jesus. Lord, I cover myself in your blood. May your name be praised forever. Father, by your supernatural hand, we pray that your divine or common favor will begin to work for our good. Where we have been rejected, doors that has been closed, let them begin to open up in the name of Jesus. May your name be praised forever. May your name be praised forever. May your name be praised forever in the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to Jesus, glory to Jesus, glory to Jesus, glory to Jesus, hallelujah. Thank you, Father, blessed be your name. Take all the glory, Father, take all the honor, Jesus, take all the adoration, my Father, my lover, lover of my soul. We just appreciate you for whom you are. We just appreciate, come on, just appreciate him as you are going. Just appreciate him as we are living now. Just glorify him. We just give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor. We give you all the adoration in the name of Jesus. May your name be praised forever. Hallelujah. 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 It is well with all of us in Jesus' name. Have a wonderful night rest. It's time to go now. We'll meet again tomorrow by his grace. From me to you, I love you. And always remember that Jesus loves you more. If you haven't shared, please share and be a blessing. God bless you. God bless you. And may he continue to bless you now and forevermore. Amen and amen and amen in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen to your prayers. I'm seeing your prayers in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Glory to you, Jesus. Bye-bye. God bless you all. Bye-bye.